darkness at the close of day, when all I think about is you. Not knowing where I'm going, what am I to do? When all I think about is you, I'll stand an hour knocking, knowing that my heart is mocking me. She doesn't live here anymore. I don't know why I bother, what else can I do? When all I think about is you. Dream maker, heartbreaker, how can dreams come true? When all I dream about is you.
Dickie! Hello! It's alright. Whoa!
Oh, bloody
oh.
It's the last bastard.
Hello, how you doing?
Yes, very well, thank you. Many happy returns, old boy, on your birthday.
Oh, thanks very much. Yeah, 19th a day. That's a nice hug, Dickie.
Yeah. Don't take this the wrong way, old boy, but you haven't got a bit of butter on you, have you?
Let me have a look. No. Unfortunately not.
Oh, well.
What do you need it for?
I think...
Would you like to go into Strawberry and get some butter?
Yeah. Let me just check what I've got here.
Oh,
yes.
Is that your storage box there? More ones just yes. over here. More ones just here.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah.
There we go for a couple of drinks with the old Rangers.
Yeah, well, I don't really know what they want to do. I've told a couple it's my birthday, but not everybody. I was thinking perhaps I'll make a load of chocolate milks to give them for my birthday.
Yes, that's a good idea. Oh. Yes, I wouldn't mind going and getting a little bit of butter, old boy.
Yeah, okay, sounds good. Shall we go then?
Yes, have you heard from Flo?
I think she might be coming to Strawberry. I mean, she said like she was going to. So hopefully we can catch her there. Hey, I was talking to Bright Dawn about you, right? And I was speaking to Bright Dawn about you, and she was I really like Dickie, he's really nice. So, you know, there might be a little bit of redemption or something.
Maybe.
But there's a recruit ranger, right, called Willie, and he knows you.
Yes.
He knows Willie. You, he's seen the boy with the tentacle.
Oh, indeed.
Yeah, he can't wait to meet you.
Oh, lovely.
Another Willie. Fan. Add it to the thousands.
What is he, English?
Or... Yeah, he's English, yeah. So he must have seen it in England.
Yeah. Yeah. That sounds exciting.
Yeah. Oh, do you know what? I need money. Shit. Pardon my potty mouth. I'm going to have to go back to me thingy.
Bank.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing. I've got like $400.
Make sure it's tucked away.
How much do you think I need, Dickie?
For what?
For today.
Oh, not much.
30. We could always go to the casino and have a little bit of a flutter.
Yeah, well, put it this way, old boy. Once we've done with the drinks with the Rangers...
Yeah. Oh, sorry.
...taken you away.
Oh. Where?
Saint-Denis.
Oh, nice.
Got a couple of things planned, including a... The boat.
Not another boat. I don't like water, Dickie.
No, the casino on the boat.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's all right. Although, I did like the rowing trip. That was a lot of fun in the end. Although, I was absolutely mortified at the start. I did actually have a little tinkle, but I didn't tell anybody.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, don't tell Flo. Good. How you been, Dickie? What you been up to?
Yes. I was meant to do an audition, no, rehearsal.
Yeah.
But with Alfie, you know, from the university.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Reliable as ever, eh?
Yes, it reminded me of those days and days where we just stood there outside the theatre together.
Yeah.
Two-bit whores.
Yeah. High-quality escorts. Should we hitch up here?
Yes, what are we doing?
You need to get butter and I need to get chocolate milk.
I must say I do love this little town.
It's nice, ain't it?
Yes. like the river flowing straight through it.
Yeah.
Wild horses, yes.
Cat got kidnapped yesterday and badly beaten up. Yeah, I know.
Oh, dear. Is she okay?
Yeah, she is, yeah.
Evening.
Hello, Deuce. How you doing?
Good, yourself?
It's all right. It's my birthday today.
Oh, really?
Happy birthday.
Yeah, I'm 19. I was thinking about, like, having a few drinks if you'd like to join us, if there's other rangers about.
I'm not much of a drinking man, I'm afraid.
What about chocolate milk? Would you like that?
Sure.
Okay, I'll go and get the chocolate milks on order.
Very well, thank you.
See you in a bit. Yeah, I thought I'd put my Midnight Cowboy outfit on.
Yes. Right, what is it you need in the shop?
Chocolate milks.
Oh, that's it.
Did you get your battle all right?
Yes, I thought you were walking just slightly behind me. I carried on walking and talking to about this point before I realised you weren't here.
Right. Yeah,
I thought you said hello and then carried on with me.
No, I just had a quick hello with Deuce, told him it's like my birthday. Yeah. Right, let's sort out these chocolate milks.
Hello.
Hello.
It's my birthday today, I'm 19.
Happy birthday, Rodney.
Thanks very much.
Come here, I gotta give you a birthday hug.
Okay.
Oh, that's lovely.
And you, it's so good to see you.
Oh, yes.
It's Dawn, Dickie.
Dawn, nice to see you again.
How are you?
Oh, yes, I'm very well, thank you. Are you well?
I am, thank you.
That is wonderful news.
Would you like a hug?
Yes.
No, thank you. Oh. I've already given him one. And a hug.
Yeah.
Yeah. Happy
birthday, darling.
And to you too.
It's not my birthday. A few months yet.
Actually, no, we're having a double birthday today, aren't we?
It was my birthday on the
21st. Oh, yes, that's right. Well, I was thinking, like, doing something with the Rangers if they want to have a lot of drink or something like that.
Yeah, that'd be good. I think that would be really good.
We need it. Yeah.
Desperately.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's nice. Got a couple of hugs from a couple of ladies, Dickie. Things are looking up for me.
Yes, I can tell.
Yeah. That's nice. You know, Dawn was nice to you, wasn't she?
I guess so.
Yeah. Right.
I deleted her from my Telegram contact book.
I can always get it back for you if you want to message her.
No.
Incognito.
No.
Okay.
She's moved on to bigger and better things.
Well, she's married now, ain't she?
Well, I mean the $55 more so.
I'll give you some money, Dickie.
No,
and we'll hear more about it.
We will continue to hear about it.
Well, of course, yeah. It's a major talking point, ain't it?
Yes. I get this horrible taste in my mouth every time you mention her name.
Oh, I'm sorry. Perhaps a chocolate milk will take the bad taste away. Let me just make it for you. I've got to give it a good shake.
Yes. Who was the other one, by the way?
That's Nadia. That's like a mother, sort of, I think.
Like mother, like daughter.
Yeah.
So what happened with Kat? Is she okay?
Yeah. Yeah, we went to St. Denis. They, like the law found her.
To whom took her?
Don't know. But we all, like a big group of us, we all went up there with all our like guns out.
Sorry.
Hello there. Hello. How you doing?
Hey, doing okay, are you?
Yeah, I'm really good today. It's my birthday. I'm 19 today.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thanks very much.
No problem.
How's things
doing
with you?
Nice?
I don't know yet. No. I've only just met Dickie. I'm just getting some chocolate milk. Would you like a chocolate milk?
I'm okay. Like, I'm not really a chocolate milk drinker.
You sure?
I am pretty sure. Yes. I mean, you can give mine to Kat if you like. I know she's probably in need of it more than I am. So.
Is she in Strawberry at the moment?
Yeah, I believe so.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. Yeah, went out and saw her yesterday. Poor thing.
No.
Yeah. It's quite emotional, all of us being there. You know, we had a big group hug.
Good.
Yeah.
Good, I'm glad you did.
Who was it that kidnapped her?
Because the case is open, I can't disclose that information, unfortunately.
Oh, okay. That's all right. Fair enough.
Yeah, sorry. But we are keeping an eye out for them and looking for them, so.
Right, so they're still on the loose then, are they?
Yeah, they would be.
Yeah.
Since the case is still open.
Yeah. Fucking ruffians. Oh, pardon my potty mouth.
Rodney, language.
Sorry.
I know, you're right. Fucking ruffians. Fucking pricks.
Yeah, I'm swearing a lot more now. McAllister. Well, yeah,
yes, because 19, that's what I'm 13. Well, yeah. I'm, yeah, the more you swear.
Well, becoming more of a manly man, aren't I?
I don't really. I mean, you can not be a manly man and swear. That is really.
Well, I'm a ranger, and I fight cougars and wolves and bears, so that's pretty manly, ain't it?
Aye, so you just say get fucked before you get a cougar.
Yeah, get fucked, cougar.
Aye, there you go, you see.
Yeah. Oh, my potty mouth is on overdrive.
Just do it before you get a bear, you know, get fucked bear.
Yeah, get fucked bear.
Oh, maybe don't say that when you don't know your game word and so.
Yeah, not in front of him, yeah. He might get a bit upset.
Yeah,
that'd
be a bit awkward.
Well, it's nice seeing you, you know.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah. How was the lady that we picked up in Wapiti? Was she all right?
No, she was good, she was fine. Everything was
that's
okay
good,
there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a relief. Okay. Yeah.
Aye. I appreciate your help as well the other day with the one out in Bodrick Lead.
Oh, right, yeah, yeah.
Aye, I always appreciate it.
Yeah, it's a shame we couldn't really, there wasn't a lot we could do, you know.
No, like I said, you did everything right, you did your best, so.
Yeah.
We couldn't ask for anything more of you.
Well, that's it, you know, and it's nice that we can all work together, you know.
Aye, exactly. Okay.
Yeah, sort them fucking ruffians out. So.
Exactly. Well, you can sort out the fucking wildlife or sort out the fucking ruffians.
How's yeah, that? Sounds good to me.
All right.
It's a deal.
Okay, all right, sounds good.
Yeah.
Take it easy, Rodney. Happy birthday.
Yeah. Thank you. You take care and have a good day.
Bye.
You all right, Dickie? Sorry about that.
Yes. No, I had to go to the butcher's briefly. Now we must go back to the camp briefly.
Okay, I'm just going to get all these chocolate milks.
Make sure you've got a little bit of space in your pocket, old boy, for about 2 apples.
Right, okay. It's a lot of hard work, all this shaking.
Yes. Thought you'd be used to it. Oh, that's what I was going to do. I was going to check the guns here.
Yeah, they've got quite a nice selection, Dickie.
Yes. What have I got? Have I got a Litchfield or a...
Lancaster.
Oh, that's a shame. That's a shame. For an extra $50, I should have got the Litchfield.
I think it carries more bullets as well.
Thank you for that.
When is your birthday? I'll buy you one.
Not until September.
Well, that's not too far off.
Yes, 5 months.
Yeah.
What's down here? I'm just going to stand out on the porch just in case.
Yeah, good idea. Okay, so I've got 8 bottles of chocolate milk.
Oh, good for you.
But we'll probably be going up to the welcome centre, I reckon. Sorry, I didn't mean to poke you in the face there.
I know, but I'm
just twiddling your moustache.
Yes, thank you.
Looks rather fine at the moment.
Oh, yeah, I've been putting plenty of wax in it, you know.
Yeah, perhaps a bit of wax, a bit of pomade might have some sort of effect on it.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
Is Flo meant to be meeting us here, then?
At the camp, I think.
Oh, at the camp, that's good.
Yeah. We'll quickly pop back to the camp, then, and you can do what you've got to do, and then we'll come back and then let the celebration begin.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, I missed him. Well, I suppose she's coming from Valentine. Yeah, it's a bit of a way.
Maybe,
yeah. Oh, yeah, you're in your tent. Oh, you're over there.
It's my little box, yes.
I've still got a couple of potions she gave me. But you know, I don't really want them because I don't do drugs.
Just drop them on the floor or something, then I'll buy it.
Do you think... But she might want them back, mightn't she, do you reckon?
Maybe.
There's never enough storage, is there, for anything?
But now...
I've got one called Go With The Flow Large Silky Blue Tonic.
Oh, that's good. And, well, don't do it, old boy, just in case, you know.
Yeah, and juice, a Zip Juice Medium Silky Brown Tonic. Perhaps when she gets here, I'll find out if she wants them. Oh, that sounds nice and sizzling in that pot.
Oh, yeah.
Have you found any new recipes recently, Dickie?
No, but I did find a nice ingredient, which is what all this is about.
Oh. I've only got one pocket space at the moment, I'm afraid.
Oh, dear.
That's what I mean. That's why I want to get rid of this bloody thing.
Right, one moment. I'll do a little bit of a trade here. I'll do the drugs.
Yeah? You'll have the drugs?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll get one. Oh, I can only get one out at a time. Got a big blue one for you.
Lovely.
that one there.
Thank you.
I'll go and get the other one. You never know what they might do.
Oh! They make me aggressive.
Oh, I haven't got a black eye. I have got a black eye. There must have been a fly or something, was it?
No, it's the big bottle of drugs I just took.
You took it straight away?
Strung the whole lot.
Are you mad?
It was involuntary, old boy. I think it makes you violent.
I think it does. My face don't half hurt. Look at my cheek.
Oh, dear.
And my lip.
This is not what I wanted your birthday to be.
No, you've ruined it, Dickie. Ruined it.
No.
No, you ain't joking. I know it's an accident. These things happen, don't they?
Right, next one.
See if you can run around fast. Cool, you are ever so fast.
Yes. Oh, dear. Vision going.
Oh, God. Sit down before you hurt yourself.
Sit down before I...
Oh, careful with your foot. It's very near the fire.
Yes.
Okay, you're right.
Yes, I'm just waiting for it to get out of my system, not by him.
Yeah. Perhaps, like, vomit a little bit or something. Stick your fingers down your throat.
Oh, dear.
Oh, God, you're in the fire, Dickie. Get up quick. Oh, no, Dickie, you're going to burn your hat.
It's involuntary, old boy.
Is it?
Smack me. Really?
I can't.
Effing smack me. Go on. I think I just need a slap to the face, old boy.
I can't hit you.
Why? Because I'm like family. Oh!
There. How's that?
One more. Oh, that'll do it.
Yeah.
I think that got it.
You all right?
Oh, yes, I think that got it, old boy.
Yeah, I was still thinking about fluffy kittens with mittens.
Oh, dear.
I couldn't hurt you at all.
Oh, vision going.
Oh, God, not again. Why is she making... Why did she give me that? For fuck's sake. Hold my potty mouth.
Right, have you got... Oh, that's better. Oh, a bit of fresh air. There we go. Got it. Now, have you got space for this? Two little thingies?
Yeah.
So, old Dickie has made you a little birthday... breakfast.
Oh, do you know what? I've been after an English breakfast for months.
Yes.
Oh, that's so kind of you.
Yes. That's lovely.
Thank you, Dickie. I've been thinking about a full English breakfast since December when I come
here. There you go, old boy.
Thank you.
Yes, you're welcome.
That's a wonderful birthday gift.
Yes, first of many.
Did you make yourself some?
Yes, and Flair. Oh, she doesn't like a sausage, does she?
No, unfortunately.
No sausage. No.
That egg is divine.
Oh, yes, alligator.
Oh, I thought, wonder why it's so large.
Yes, meaty.
Oh, that sausage is lovely. Did you pack it with herbs when you made it?
Yes.
That's lovely.
Yes.
Quite salty as well.
Oh, yes. That's the first of many little exciting things.
Oh, today. I'm very, very excited. I'm so excited, I just want to run around.
Where the bloody hell flow?
I don't know. I told her, like, the camp. I hope she's not gone back to Rhodes. We just dropped some bottles there.
Yes, I don't want them.
Okay. No, it's not a... Oh. Can't beat a nice fire, can you?
No, I don't deny this. If you place a fire like here, because I want it to be nice and warm while I slept, lights up the whole of this place for miles around. Really, it's quite bright.
Right. I'm just hoping that people just ignore it, even if they see it. They just think, well, there's no one there.
No.
I think as long as we, you know, flare our horses off into the nearby meadow, then they probably won't suspect anything, because a lot of people do look for, like, horses.
Yes. Oh, I just realised I ate Flora's egg.
Oh. We just won't tell her then about the cooked breakfast.
Yes. I just have a little bit of water.
Yeah, I'm a bit thirsty. I think it's quite salty, wasn't it, that sausage?
Oh, I was dehydrated because of the drug intake.
I was just dehydrated because I haven't had a drink today.
Yeah.
Oh, nice fresh strawberry water, that is.
Oh, yes. What do you want to do then, old boy? Do you want to go into the store over there, just in case she comes down?
Yeah, I mean, she'll probably pass through that way, won't she? So she's about to look at the rangers.
Yes.
I mean, she comes here and we're not here, then she's hopefully put two and two together and realised that we're up at Strawberry. Just hope Wolves haven't got her. You know what her luck's like.
Oh, yes. I did send her a little telegram. I might check to see if she responded, because we were going to travel together, but I thought she might have already been here.
Ah, sorry.
I spent the last couple of days, well, you know, evenings, if you will, with Flora.
All right.
Yeah, we went into the swamps looking for flowers and herbs and things.
Yeah.
And then I bumped into her only very briefly for, I don't know, 20 minutes or so yesterday.
Right.
She was looking to make some flour for the peach cobbly.
Oh, right,
so
yeah.
I took her out of the wheat field, yes.
Oh, nice. That's nice that... Oh, right. Well, it's nice that, you know, you can do stuff together when I'm doing, like, rangering stuff.
Yes, we were at risk of, friendship only working when you're around, but actually we get on like a house on fire.
Well, that's brilliant. That's really good. You all right there?
Yes. Monty had a bit of a wobble.
No. Oh. I'll go and start handing out the chocolate milks.
Yes, I'll just go and check my telegram.
Actually, I need to sort out my telegrams. Hello.
Yes.
Hi.
We'll be back over in a minute. We're just going to go to the telegrams.
Got a call, so,
Have you?
Yeah.
Oh, we'll stay safe.
In a minute. It's in the Big Valley, so it's okay.
Okay. All right. There's a lot of chickens around here, and perhaps you'd be able to find some eggs.
Yes, maybe.
There's a lot of horse shit about as well, isn't there?
Plenty of that to go around, isn't there?
Yeah.
These are $100 shoes.
Oh, gold. Look after them, don't get them too muddy. to keep polishing them.
Yeah. Well, where the bloody hell has she got to?
Oh. Telegram from you. Many happy returns.
Oh, you didn't see that one yet?
No, I've only just reading it now.
Oh, lovely.
I've got a nice one from Flo wishing me happy birthday as well.
How long ago was that?
I'll just double check.
Here, this note about the meals for the Ranger Ball.
About 20 minutes ago, I suppose.
Oh, maybe she's on her way then.
Yeah. What's that?
What about this little poster here about the Saints Crossing Ranger Ball?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to that. It's not till May.
And do you know what sort of time that would be?
I think it's going to be like 11 o'clock our sort of time. Oh, there she is. Hello.
Oh, hello.
How you doing?
Happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Yeah.
Hello,
Dickie. Hello, Flo. How are you?
Oh, I'm good, thank you. You?
Oh, yes. Wonderful. Oh. Wonderful. Wonderful. Uh-huh. Wonderful.
Yeah.
I've got a load of chocolate milk, like birthday chocolate milk, to give to the Rangers and it. Would you like one? Do you like chocolate milk?
Okay, yes, please.
There you go. Oh. It's very nice.
Yeah, I made it for you.
Scalloped potato. That's my favourite.
Yeah. Oh, that's good.
Oh, it looks all nice and crispy on the top.
Yeah.
Thanks ever so much.
I put some chickens on the top as well.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I hope you don't get a, Dickie Termy from me.
No, I'm sure it'd be fine.
Oh, that's good.
Smells delicious.
And a candy bag as well. That's perfect.
Yeah. Oh.
Thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome. Thank
what
you.
What a birthday.
Yeah, it's all happening. I'm ever so excited.
Yeah,
are you?
Yeah. It's all coming
19. Yeah, I know, 19.
Do you feel old?
A little bit older, yeah. I feel more like a man. Now I've passed 18.
Yeah.
But not as manly as Dickie, because he's obviously quite a lot older than me.
Oh, yes. Well, I'm quite the man, you see. Quite manly.
Well, yeah. Well, that's what, the ladies have been whispering about.
Yes, I've heard.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Well, what are we doing? What are we doing there? We're going to go have a couple of drinks.
Okay.
Yeah, I think the Rangers have all gone.
Did they say that they all went off together? I assume they
were. I saw a few riders all go absolutely belting it out of here.
Yeah, they just got a call. Yeah, search
see.
And rescue.
Oh dear, that's not good.
No.
Yes.
It might be a while.
Hmm.
This is a bit of a shame.
Yeah.
Yes.
What should we do? Go up to the welcome centre and have a drink up there.
Yeah. Might as well, old boy.
Okay. Mind the mud and the shit.
Williams, is that you?
Oh, is he talking to somebody?
Oh, he's talking to that gentleman in the door there.
All right. Let's find out what he's talking about. It's nice to see you, Flo. How you been?
Yes. Oh, yes. I remember you.
Yes,
I wrote you a little love letter asking about other items and you never responded to me, you bastard.
Maybe you came on too soon, unless it's a priority from the company, but I can look back and see what the ladies had opened up.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, it's my birthday today. I'm 19.
Happy birthday, fella.
Thanks very much. Dickie. Mind the whole shit.
Oh, yeah. I keep treading in it.
Yeah, it stinks, doesn't it?
Somewhere
to be around here. I know. Look, there's a load of it there. Mm. I used to clear that sort of stuff up when I was in Colchester, when I worked in the market, shoveling up horse shit. Yeah.
Mm. Right, drinks are on me.
Oh.
$1.
Okay, I'll have a ginger beer then, please. Or do you think I should have a beer?
The night is young.
Yeah, ginger beer first then.
I will have a wheat beer, please.
I don't want to be absolutely bollocks for my birthday.
No. You'll end up tied to a lamppost somewhere in Saint Denis.
Yeah, with a feather up my arse.
And maybe more.
Yeah.
Flo, will you take a step to your right, please? Thank you. And then, Flo, you change places with Rodney.
Thank you, Dickie.
You're most welcome. Bloody hell.
Let me get out of the way over here.
One of your finest beers.
Thank you very much.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers. Any happy returns, old boy? Cheers.
Yum, yum, yum. Oh, that's nice, that is. I like the ginger.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
It's very refreshing. What have you got, Dickie? You got like ordinary manly beer?
No, I'm a ginger beer as well.
Oh.
Ginger beer is all round.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, it's very refreshing. It's nice on a hot day having something like that. Mm.
Too bad it's always
what?
Freezing bloody cold up here.
Yeah, it is quite chilly, isn't it? I should probably roll my sleeves down, but I quite like them up. You know, looks a bit more manly. What do you reckon, Flo?
It does, yeah, it does look more manly.
Yeah, and my neckerchief, that looks very manly, don't it?
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is pleasant.
It's very nice.
How's your rehearsals going? Did that man turn out last night? Or the night before, or whenever it was?
No, never turned up. He sent me a little love letter saying he got waylaid, so I forgive him, I guess. But now he's gone off on university work for the next week, apparently, so I won't see the bastard.
Oh, dear.
Yes, typical actress.
And is that talking stayed out of trouble?
Yes. Rehearsals tomorrow at 5 p.m. That's 10 p.m. in old money.
Mm-hmm.
So that'll be something to look forward to. But I told you, did I tell you? Oh my God, I don't think I told you, Rodney.
What? Tell me.
No, I did tell you because I didn't want to take all the mystique out of your birthday about me and the theatre owning it.
Yeah, I think it's brilliant news.
Yeah.
Oh, that was super exciting, right?
Yeah. So when do you actually take it over? Because I noticed, like, Maxwell was there the last time we went. You know, when we had our little boat trip. Was it our boat trip the last time we was there?
Yes, it was the day after I saw him.
Right.
And he told me all about it. And then I saw you, didn't I, that later on that time?
Yeah.
Outside Saint Denis.
Yeah.
So Rose and I co-own it, and I'm taking her for dinner on Friday to discuss plans.
Oh, where are you taking her?
Oh, I'll be taking her up the Bastille.
Oh.
How fancy.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how old is she then, Dickie?
Don't like to ask, old boy.
Yeah, you're not supposed to do that, are you? Does she look like... sort of your age then, Dickie, or...?
I'd say slightly younger, but not too much younger, yeah.
That's a result, isn't it?
Not that Maggie Rowley that's about 20 years older than you.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, she's a hot mess, isn't she?
Yeah, would be a lot of dust blowing about there.
Talcum powder. I am giving her an elixir that'll help her.
Oh, what a youth elixir. Make her younger.
Kind of like a fountain tap one.
Oh. Oh, that'll help, won't it?
Yeah, whenever I hear from her, but Dickie says she only gets it once a week.
Right.
So,
yes, if that.
Yeah.
So she never did that raffle on Monday like she said she was going to.
What a bitch.
She's a scammer.
Yeah.
She is a skank, yes.
Con artist.
Yes.
So, you don't think you're batting above your average then with this Rose lady? Do you think you can, you know, clinch the deal and, you know, take her on a nice picnic?
Well, I think the meal at the Bastille is a bit nicer than a picnic, but, yes.
But you know what I mean?
Do you mean plower?
No.
You mean the Dickie buffet?
Yeah. Like, sort of, you know, start not seeing her on a regular basis.
Well, without getting too strange about it, old boy.
Yeah.
She, well, my body clock's the same as yours, but she's only just arrived from the very west coast of the United States.
Oh, dear.
Oh, Dickie, there's always some problem, ain't there?
Yes.
You're going to have to sack her off then, do you reckon?
Oh, yes. Sack her off, I'd say. Yeah, so...
Or maybe just she could be your weekend lady.
Yeah.
Yes. So, you know, to me it feels like it's about 9 p.m, but to her it would be about midday.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So, chances are, old boy. Yeah.
She's going to be wide awake and you're going to be, like, snoring your head off, aren't you?
Yes, which I guess is okay in terms of the theatre, running the theatre. You know, it'll be open for much longer, but just means any coordination, usually via correspondence rather than in person.
Yeah, yeah. Do you know what? She walked straight past me in the theatre and I was saying, hello, how you doing? She just, just snubbed me, like, oh, shit on her shoe. Oh, pardon my potty mouth. I think it's the theatre.
At drama club the other night.
Well... That was the drama club thing, wasn't it? Oh. Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
What were you about to say about the theatre people?
I was going to say, are they all a bit sort of, you know, snooty, do you think, Dickie? I mean, you've worked in the theatre. You must have met quite a lot of them that are right up their own arseholes. Oh, pardon my potty mouth.
Well, some of them can be a bit pretentious. Luckily, I'm not.
No, far from it.
But, but she is slightly, but she, you know, she's new and she's very excited about the whole thing.
And she's got a very big hat. I think that adds to it.
Yes. But we played this game where, it's quite an exciting game, where two people are on stage and the first person starts and their opening letter of the sentence starts with A, and then the next person talks and it's B, see, all the way through. And it was me and her to show everybody how it's done, and she couldn't. She kept messing it all up, old boy.
Oh, that's no good at all. I don't think she's the right one for you, Dickie.
No.
I think you've got better standards.
She's not your counterpart then, is she?
No.
No.
Not your soulmate.
No. The game itself is actually very easy. Would you like to give it a go? Just hear the three of us.
Is it like a
birthday game? Yeah.
Yes, so I'll start a sentence and the first letter will start with an A. Rodney, you'll say the next thing, but it'll start with the B and C and all the way around.
I'm not quite sure. You'll have to give me an example.
So I would say, and how are you doing, Rodney? And you might say, but Dickie, I'm doing marvellously.
Oh,
and then Flo will say, certainly, glad to hear it. So it's like...
Right, yes. Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, I'm not sure my brain's going to be fast enough, but I'll try.
I'm struggling already, and it's not even started.
Now, Anyone got a lovely place to recommend to go to visit?
Better try the Welcome Centre.
Could try Saint Denis.
Depends on the weather, I guess.
Everybody goes there. It's absolutely splendid.
For fuck's sake, I don't want to go where everyone else goes.
Good, me neither.
Horrible place, I've heard, actually.
I heard it's real stinky.
Just because you heard that doesn't mean it is.
Kettle calling pot black or something. Oh,
yeah. Like I would know anything about that.
Methinks you would.
No, I don't think she does.
Well, I don't know. I could tell you anything and you believe it.
Perhaps we should go to Saint Denis for your birthday soon, Rodney.
Queen Victoria often goes there, I've heard.
She's dead.
Really? Do I have to do more than one word in a sentence?
No. Stupendous idea. Let's go to Saint Denis soon.
Tremendous idea indeed.
Unbelievable that you have made this decision.
Very much so.
What's next?
You. Do you?
W.
Well, let's all go.
For fuck's sake. Thanks.
It's tricky.
Ecstatically, let's go.
Are you sure, Rodney? No, I said, how are you? You sure you want to, Rodney?
The zoo is out of the question.
Yes.
Oh, it's good, yeah.
Oh, my poor brain hurts.
Yeah, mine is throbbing.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Well, if the Rangers aren't doing this, perhaps we can come back here to finish the year.
Lady standing on the chair just staring at me. It's quite disconcerting.
Oh, she's sitting there. She's sitting there fanning herself. I think she's getting all hot and bothered under the collar.
She's just done some sort of strange hand gesture.
How much for Rodney? It's his birthday.
Oh, God, no, Dickie. I don't want to lose my virginity to that lady.
$300.
She's having a laugh, ain't she?
Yes,
having a tin bath. That's Cockney, Dickie.
How is it?
Come on, Flo. After
a
you.
Tin bath.
Yeah, having a laugh.
What should we do? Should we enter Saint Denis in the dark, or do you want to wait?
Let's go over to the Rangers and see if they're back, and then I can hand out all these chocolate milks and see if they want to come back up there for a nice drink. I was just saying to Flo, there's an awful lot of horse shit around, and I don't normally see it as much as this.
Yeah.
Look, there's a big pile of three blobs in one spot there.
Did you tell Dickie about that wizard we saw in
St. Helens? Oh, no, yeah, we saw Wizard Dickie.
Yeah, you told me. He came
to that's right. Yeah. Well, he was working behind the bar.
Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't want to tread in that shit.
A bar wizard.
Yeah, he was standing there with no trousers on.
He
didn't have his big hat on, though.
Oh. You know, it was strange. He took part in drama club. He was absolutely wonderful.
Yeah, I think you should sign him up.
Yes.
Absolutely spellbinding, Dickie.
Yeah.
Did you see what I did there?
A real acting wizard.
Oh, yeah, spellbinding. I got it.
Yeah. I'm going to go and get this chocolate milk to Deuce. Oh, Deuce, would you like your chocolate milk, or are you a bit busy?
I can take it, Ruby.
Okay. There you go.
Thank you.
Enjoy that.
That I will. Thank you very much.
No problem. Hey, how you been
doing?
Happy
birthday.
Oh, thank you. How you been doing? You all right after everything yesterday?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Yeah. Just glad that she's, you know, she's safe, eh?
One of the only things that matter. Is there anything I can help you with? Anything you need?
No, I'm all good, you know. I was just waiting for the Rangers to come back, and then we was probably going to go up to the Welcome Centre and have a drink, if you fancy it.
Well, maybe. We'll see.
Yeah, all right, no problem.
Right, shouldn't be gone too long.
No, shouldn't be. But, what was it, Big Valley, wasn't it, they went to, I think?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'll be back on duty tomorrow anyway.
All right.
I'll see you later, Deuce. You look after yourself.
Then I will.
You can get one in the bayou.
Yeah, I saw that one. That's good, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. I think they're quite gentle waters in the bayou, right?
Yeah. Oh, we're back.
Hmm. Do you want to do we take them up the guest house?
Yeah. Do you fancy coming for a drink at the Welcome Centre, do you?
A second, once I've done the paperwork and stuff like that.
Yeah, okay. I've got all lot of paperwork and stuff to do. Hopefully, I shouldn't be too long. Shouldn't take, you know, too long just to fill it out.
Yeah, hopefully not.
Yeah.
Was that Dawn?
I'm not a fan of paperwork. Yeah. Dawn? Have I heard of her?
Yeah, she's the lady that Dickie, when she first came to the crossing, helped out quite a bit.
Ah, oh, right. I knew I'd heard the name somewhere.
Yeah.
Yes, now I'm dead to her.
Oh, she doesn't even say hello to you.
Oh, she did, yes, in all fairness.
Oh, okay.
But when I first got here, she said hello.
Yeah, she's nice. Nadia's like, you know, like her guardian. She's ever so nice as well.
Yes.
I made her absolutely, like, almost wet herself with laughing the other day because I was busting for a tinkle. And, you know, I told them about my lazy bladder. And we had to stop. And, you know, when I sort of finished having a tinkle, I turned around, they were all, like in a line, you know. And they said we was on guard and we wasn't watching. And I said, well, you know, I did get a little bit of stage fright, and she absolutely lost it. She was laughing for ages.
No.
Yeah. She had to get on the back of Alfred's horse because she was laughing so much.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no. Who are these two young ladies coming down from the doctor's office?
Oh, that's Kat. Yeah.
Yes.
Hello, Kat. How are you?
Hello.
This is Rodney. He's one of our rangers.
Nice to meet you.
It is good to meet you as well. Deputy Joanna Briggs.
Hello, nice to meet you.
She's my best friend.
Oh, that's nice. It's my birthday today. I'm 19.
Oh, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
I've got some birthday chocolate milk. Would you like one?
I think I'm good, but thank you.
Kat, would you like a nice birthday chocolate milk?
Only if you tell me how it tastes. Is
ever
it
so nice?
Ever so nice, perfect.
That's the magic word, ain't it?
Thank you. Yeah. I love when Rodney says that.
Oh,
excuse me, sir. Yeah, and the same to you too. With brass knobs on. Sorry. Honestly, some of the locals are so rude round here. Especially with it being my birthday. Dickie's over there, look. And my friend Flo. Have you met Flo? I think you have, haven't you?
I think briefly, but not properly.
Yeah. I was thinking of going up to the Welcome Centre for a drink. Are you up to it? Are you...
I think I'm going to get a few things from the lodge first, but
yeah,
that could be nice.
Yeah, how are you feeling today? Are you any better?
Yeah, I'm doing a lot better.
It's good. I was ever so worried about you yesterday when When Nadia told me I was ready to get on my horse and go out looking for you. But she had to send me on a patrol just to take my mind off it.
Honestly, when I came out of the sheriff's office and I saw all of you, after I gave my statement, that made my heart so full.
Yeah, it was lovely. It was, you know, it was just lovely to see you, that you know, you was okay and you got, you know, you weren't being held captive anymore. Yeah, we all care about you so much. You know, you are like our mother, really. I know you're far too young to be a mother, but yeah, you are like our mother. We'd be all be lost without you. Isn't that right, Nadia? She's like our mother,
Absolutely.
Ain't she? Yeah. You're like the auntie, aren't you?
Yeah, the one that spoils everyone.
Yeah, that's it. The nice auntie, not the tight one.
Then who's the tight one?
I don't think we have an auntie like that, fortunately. They're all lovely. Mm. And all
this
the other rangers are like brothers and sisters, really. Sort of, you know, just one big happy family.
Good. Well, right. Let's get you those bullets.
I'll let you get on and do what you need to do, and if you're up for it, we'll go for a nice drink.
Thank you.
That's no problem.
I appreciate
that. So lovely to see you again.
Honestly, thank you.
It's all right.
I will. By the way, just again to remind people, it is so important, so important that the Rangers don't go towards Blackwater or, you know, even through Strawberry tonight. Stay careful. If you hear a lot of horses riding through, get into the lodge and lock it. Okay.
Right. Okay. So who is it
it's
that's
really
targeting us then?
They're not targeting the Rangers per se.
They can
the
be
Lobos
very violent,
might be.
Though.
Yeah. Just,
just ruffians.
Stay, ruffians. Just stay calm and just take all of the recruits and all of the Rangers inside until you hear the horses, you know, gone.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I was planning going to St. Denis tonight to go to the casino for my birthday.
Yeah.
Do you think that's all
I think St. Denis would be fine.
Yeah,
that would be safe.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Just don't go to Blackwater or Strawberry.
Right, okay, no problem.
Alright.
Okay,
thank you.
I need to go send a telegram.
Okay.
Oh dear, what was I to be?
Well, there's a lot of ruffians about that, been, you know, not so much targeting us, the Rangers, but if they get an opportunity to get one of us, they're going to get one of us. You know, they're just a bunch of fucking ruffians. Oh, pardon my bloody mouth. But, yeah, she just said, like, keep away from Blackwater and Strawberry, really.
Oh, dear.
And, like, you know, when we're doing, like, paperwork on the porch, not to be out there on our own, just looking at a clipboard. Because I can, three of them got robbed on the porch the other day.
Oh my goodness.
Some fella come round the back and put a gun at one of their heads and said, give us, you know, your money and that. Yeah, I mean, the cheek of it, one robber taking on three fellas, I mean.
Yeah, very dangerous as well.
Yeah, what's the world coming to?
Yeah, it's diabolical.
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
So,
what do you want to do then, Rodney? Because I don't see many Rangers wanting to go for a little drink, and we've got a couple of plans, you know, if you want more, old boy.
Yeah, I think we better go, haven't we? I don't know where the Rangers have gone now.
Let's go to the knee.
Well, we're going to say to me, we'll come here before we retire for the night, and maybe someone might want to come for a drink then.
Yeah, I mean, I've got loads of this chocolate milk on me.
Oh, dear.
You're going to have to put your chocolate milk loads all over somewhere else, I think.
Yeah, perhaps I'll give Dawn some chocolate milk. Have I given her chocolate milk? I don't know. Would you like a chocolate milk?
I would absolutely love chocolate milk.
Okay.
Thank you.
There you go, no problem.
Did you see where Nadia went?
She's gone inside.
Oh,
No, she's gone to do her telegrams. Sorry, yeah.
Okay. I'm Dawn.
Let's go to St. Denis then, and we'll come back this way later, and I can always go and make some more chocolate milk, can't I?
Yeah. Let's go.
Okay, I was just going to say goodbye to Kat. We're off to the casino now, Kat, so we'll come back this way later.
Stay safe.
Yeah, you too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, look after yourself. Bye-bye, deputy. It is deputy,
happy
isn't
birthday.
It?
Yes.
Yeah. Thanks very much. Yeah, 19, eh? Can't believe it. I'm growing up into a manly man.
No. Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
You know what you're meant to get on your 19th birthday, right?
What's that?
Well, in my family, sometimes we punch each other, but not going to do that to you.
Thank
also,
God.
My shoulder hurts, but...
Yeah. Maybe when, when you're better.
Is it the bumps?
Oh, that's very nice.
You have
nice.
To give them the number of the year that they are.
Oh, so, thanks very much.
$19.
Yeah, that's great. I'll try and double it and give you the winnings at the casino.
You're combat 38 years old.
Yeah. Oh, have I introduced you, Kat? This is my friend Flo. Flo, this
Hello,
is...
Howdy.
This is Kat.
Oh.
And that's
it's
a Dickie.
Yep, that's me. Oh.
Yeah, Walter gave me your telegram number, actually. I was going to telegram you to discuss some herbs.
I would love to.
Oh, that's good.
I adore
when you're
Walter.
Feeling better, obviously.
Thank you. Yeah, that sounds wonderful.
Yeah.
I hope you all have a lot of fun.
Yeah, we will do. Thanks so much. It's a nice birthday present. Thank you.
Of course.
You take care.
I'm sorry it's not more, but those are the rules. You can get more next year.
Yeah.
You'll
get 20.
Yep, you'll get a whole $20.
Yeah. Well, you go and sit down over there and take it steady, all right?
Yeah, hope you feel better soon.
Yes.
I'll see you tomorrow if you're about, Kat.
Yep, I will be.
Okay.
Stay safe.
You too.
I care.
Bye, deputy.
Yes.
Right, let's go then. Are you coming on my horse, Flo? Flo, did you want to come on my horse?
Yeah, we're just looking for Rodney's horse. Rodney, where's your horse?
It's up here, I was just going to say.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm glad you found it now.
Yeah. My name's Flora, and you are...
My name's Charlie Baker.
Charlie Baker. Oh, nice to meet you. Mm-hmm.
Pleasure's all mine, miss. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's Rodney's birthday today. He's 19.
Yeah, I'm 19 today. Are you a recruit ranger, are you?
Happy birthday, but no, I'm not.
Oh, right.
No.
Okay. Would you like a chocolate milk at all?
I'm all right, thank you, good sir. That's very kind of you, though.
Okay, no problem.
I see you got a good taste in hats, though, good sir.
Oh, yeah. We must have gone to the same hat shop.
Yes, we have.
Yeah, it looks very good on you.
Thank you. I think yours makes you look very young.
Oh, thanks very much. Well, I'm only 19.
You're young anyway. Younger than me, that's for sure.
Yeah. Right, anyway, we've got to get going, but it's nice talking to you.
Pleasure meeting
you, Charlie.
Yeah, you take care.
Take it easy, everyone. There's a bear out there. Be careful.
Yeah. Don't worry. I'm a ranger. Don't worry. Yeah, Moonshadow's just up here. Look.
Oh, I just realised that me and Dickie have the same style of hair.
Oh.
Colours.
Oh yeah. We got to go that way. He's waiting for us, look. Everybody's so nice, aren't they, in the Rangers?
Oh, they're very friendly.
Yeah. You know who's trying to join the Rangers at the moment?
Who?
Edwin Braithwaite.
No, he's a famous man. He's a rich man, isn't he?
Well, he's from the Dead End Gang.
The what?
The Dead End Gang, you know, the gang that Wallaby's in.
Oh. I don't know who that is. Is it?
Yeah, the Wallaby Kid.
Oh, I might have. Yeah, I read about him in the paper.
Yeah, and he's supposedly turning over a new leaf. You know, wanting to be like a sort of, you know, a good person. But, you know, we've been told that, you know, we can't take him out on any patrols. But, you know, when I was a little boy, I used to love reading about the Dead End Kids. So I'd love to take him on a patrol, but, you know, he'd probably, like, rob me or something, or worse.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I read about that gang in the paper. They're real nasty. Yeah. I forgot their name.
Yeah, so, Ryder. So, yeah, it's, you know, it's quite, you know, it's quite sort of nice to sort of see him, if you know what I mean, because he's ever so nice to us all, and he bought us a big box of medical kits, and,
That's really kind.
Yeah, but, he just can't be trusted, really.
No.
I mean, I do believe people, you know, deserve a second chance, but, you know, if they're up to no good, then, you know, they're not going to get in the Rangers, are they?
No, they're not. Did I tell you that I have now got a job?
Oh, yeah, you was telling me.
At the elixir shop.
Yeah, making potions.
Yeah.
How's
and
that
gathering herbs.
All right. Well,
I'll be starting very soon. I need to pick lots of time because Abigail has received a big order from someone who wants to be buying several boxes of tonics a week.
Right.
So, and these tonics are going to need a lot of time in there.
Right.
Where does the time grow?
Oh, around the heartland.
Speaking of, around the heartlands.
Oh. Yeah, the heartlands, yeah.
Well, Flo, it's quite dangerous there, Flo, if you ever go.
I know.
Yeah, there's a lot of robbers.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. That'll be very kind of you.
No problem.
But that elixir store is beautiful. I really love it. And she said I can sleep in there too, as long as I don't, you know, climb into her bed.
So where is this place?
Oh, it's in Saint Denis, next to the Garden of Eden.
Oh, right. You all right, Dickie?
Oh, yeah.
Has she got a big bed then, has she?
Well, I didn't look in her room.
Right.
But she said if I wanted to, I could sleep on the rug in the shop. Right. Or, I said that if it's a nice dry night, I'll probably go outside and sleep in a hammock or something.
Yeah.
Because I like sleeping under the stars.
Yeah. Where are we going, Dickie?
I know, I'm following you.
Down this way. Watch out, there's a cliff there. Oh, there's the road. Are you there, Dickie?
Yes, I'm here.
She might be a little bit, you know, a bit funny.
Oh. Oh, she's got a really lovely voice. She sounds like she's been smoking a big old bowl of weed, but, you know.
Right. What, dandelions?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
She kind of sounds like that, you know.
And what's her name?
That's her voice. Abigail.
Do you know her, Dickie? You
met her?
Abigail.
No, Abigail. No, never heard of her. Oh, I've been to the shop there. It's absolutely beautiful.
I've not seen it.
Oh, you should go.
Oh, you should definitely
it's
go.
It's so beautiful. And I am going to move my storage there, though, because it'll be much easier for testing the tonics and making the tonics.
Yeah.
And,
oh, sorry.
It's my place to say, Flo, but if you mentioned your friend's non-trip back to England.
Mick. So Mick did not go back to England in the end because he had trouble getting the boat.
Right.
And so he is back now, and he got robbed again.
Really? Who boy?
In the Valentine. Oh, apparently by some man that was going around robbing loads of people, and it's the same man who robbed a train, I think, 3 times in one day.
Really?
Mm.
Well, what's the law doing? That's, you know...
I don't know.
Goodness me.
I'm pretty sure that's a bit excessive, you know.
It is, I think so.
Yeah.
Surely he'd be, exiled or something for once he's called.
At least
made
hung.
To leave the state, yeah.
At least hung.
At least hung. The minimum he could be is dead.
Yeah. I think that's... Oh, watch out, riders.
Sorry.
Oh! Oh, no! Oh, poor Dickie.
Okay. You're right, Dickie.
Here, I've got a medical bag. Let me.
Oh, thank you.
It's all right. The wind just got knocked out of me.
Step back a little bit so I can
get. Yeah. Okay. I mean, I'm a ranger. I could get him up as well. But if you want to do it, that's fine. Are you all right, Dickie?
You can get him up.
Yeah, I'll get him up because you look like you're in a hurry. Yeah.
Sorry, gentlemen.
No, I appreciate it. Sorry about that. A little miscommunication there. And how are we going on?
My fault entirely.
All right, I'm going to take the blame here, right?
It's my birthday today.
Oh,
I'm 19.
And thanks for having
me. Yeah, sorry, Dickie, I'll get you up. Thank you. Take care. Stop riding into people.
It was my fault.
I'm going to have to move you, Dickie.
Oh, Dickie.
You're in a sort of fetal position.
Yeah, well...
Get out of the way, you bloody ruffian. Honestly.
The fetal position was the one that hurt the least.
Yeah.
Gently.
Sorry. Here we go. I can get at you now.
Right. Here's your hat here as well, Dickie.
Thank you. What are you doing with your hand, Rodney?
It's just by your crotch. I'm not touching it.
To get him up.
Yeah. I'm not caressing it or anything. Look, see, I moved it back. Oh, no, it's gone back down here again. Yeah. Well, it looked like you damaged yourself there. You got like a big grass stain in your crutch.
Yeah. Last thing I saw was the sky was down and the floor was up.
Yeah. That is really bad that they actually rode into us. I mean, they should know better about bloody riding, but... I think the thing with deputies is like their policy is you get out of the way for them, but you know, how are we supposed to know that?
Well, I didn't know they were deputies.
No.
I was getting out of the way, but they went the same bloody way.
Yeah, exactly.
I thought they were locals.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which
yeah.
deputies are they then?
I don't know.
Oh, you didn't know them?
No, I didn't really know them.
One of them I got $80 out of the other day.
You should definitely ask for compensation.
Yeah.
Where there's blame, there's a claim, Dickie.
Yeah.
Yes, it did.
Yeah.
Flo, did I tell you about my $280 for 10 minutes work?
No.
Well, I met a bunch of ruffians in Rhodes. Oh, they were the people that took you that time. Oh, a load of people are coming, I think.
The mullets?
The mullets, yes.
Look at him riding along with his gun out. Who does he think he is?
Oh, twat.
Oh, God, there's more people coming there. 3 of them.
Oh. Is it the Pickerings? Was it them that you encountered?
Yes. Anyway, I was...
There you go. I'll pick your hat up for you.
I got it.
Let me get you
tell
up.
Tell me about these Pickerings, Ian.
I'll just lay here and tell you about the Pickerings. I was their paid hostage. They gave me $200 to be their hostage.
Oh.
For a bank robbery. I told you, I'm sure.
Which bank?
roads. And then, oh, that's better. And then, thank you, old boy.
That's all right.
And then, when the law came and said, oh, you know, did they take anything from you? I said, yes, $80. And they were like, oh, what are they doing taking $80 from you? They would have got loads from the bank. And I was like, I know, they're so petty.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, well, I'm going to tell them next time that they took a bolt-action rifle from me.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, I pitched it at 80 because I thought, you know, they'd pay you out of their own pocket.
Of course they do. Yeah, I got $100 from them when the Pickerings took my cat on one.
Oh, that's good.
It's all right, isn't it? Yeah, up the ante a bit, Dickie. Go up to at least 100, eh? Round it up a bit.
Yes, well, I realised if I'd got caught for, effectively being part of the gang, because that's what I was, then I probably would have been hung, old boy, so I've had to retire from that.
Well, you would have been sent to Sissico, and then God knows what would have happened. You'd have been buggered left, right and centre, being so pretty.
Oh, yes. Well, that's what they said.
Yeah. Right, shall we, are you feeling all right to ride now? I think that other group was the Italian mob.
Oh.
Yeah, I think that other group that ran through was the Italian mob, Dickie.
Oh, dear.
Which ones are the chains out? The ones that were banned from Saint Denis?
Yeah.
I read about that in the paper. Actually, I do need to get a newspaper. I haven't read it this week.
Do you want to get one at the General Store in Rhodes?
Yeah.
Okay. You all right, Dickie?
Newspaper. I have not read the news this week.
Oh, a bit wibbly wobbly.
Yeah. Oh, Dickie, I bought a shovel.
Oh, lovely. Yes, we were saying, Rodney, while you were working, you know, to support us all, that, we're going to, the three of us next time, we're going to do a bit of treasure hunting.
Oh, yeah. Well,
we'll
get robbed again. Yeah. I think that was the last time we did it, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Well, we might be all right, the three of us. You know, if it happens again, we will whip our weapons out and then they'll be completely fucked. Oh, pardon my potty mouth. Dickie, you all right? You're all wibbly wobbly, aren't you?
No, I'm pulling left and it's going right. Oh, there's the old... gun out.
Yeah, gun out guns merchant.
Sun's out, gun's out.
Slowing down for town. Look out. He was going to ride into me, wasn't he? What is wrong with people? Just because it's my birthday? There you go, Flo. You can go and get a newspaper. There's not as much old shit in this town, is there? No, I'm all right, thanks. Strawberry, honestly, it's like... It's getting like Valentine. Yeah, someone ought to do something about it.
Yeah, it's horseshit central.
Yeah, well, you know, I used to... You know, when I lived in Colchester, I had a little job at the market. That's what I used to do, was shovel up old shit all day and load up wagons and that, so... I've sort of gone up in the world and I've been a ranger.
Oh, yes. You've stepped up from the horseshit. Stepped into the horseshit.
Yeah. Up you get. Okay.
Hi.
Are you still feeling wibbly and wobbly?
A tiny bit, but I'm worried about Monty. His head's dropping. Do I need to give him any
food?
I gave him an apple. What do you want?
Keep feeding him.
Does he need some tonic? Because he might have been there.
Yeah, a tonic, yeah. Good thinking, Flo. Yeah.
They did ram right into him.
Oh, blimey.
Poor Monty. He probably got injured at the same time as Dickie.
Yeah. Oh, it looked like they probably wrote, like, he's hurt his neck, hadn't he? Poor thing. I thought he was going to go out of the stable. I thought that's where they did it. But he's getting something for the doctors for a horse.
Abigail suggested I get a second horse just in case, you know, my horse got tired from, going around collecting herbs.
I mean, have you got, like, a lot of money in the bank? I mean, how much are you thinking of spending?
Oh, not much. She said get, like, a cheap one that I could, you know, just like a Morgan or something. It's surprisingly good.
Get a Kentucky, for the money. Kentucky saddle, like Hazel. It's, honestly, he's ever such a good horse.
What do you think? Are you thinking of getting a new horse?
Just a second horse, because Abigail said sometimes when you're, you know, riding around looking for herbs all the time, your horse can get real tired or scared. So it's nice to have the second horse, and if I get saddlebags for it, I can keep herbs in there too.
Yeah, that's very true. They're good for storage. Yeah.
Well, I am quite ruthless with my storage.
Rider.
You know, Stephen, the horse.
Yeah, I love Stephen.
Well, he's a Crillio or whatever it was. Yeah. You can have him if you want, old girl.
Oh, are you sure?
Yeah, yes. Can have Stephen.
Oh, thank you. Oh, that'd be nice.
I still don't understand the concept of giving a horse to somebody, so someone might have to explain that.
Oh, more. I think you have to pay $100 for a deed.
Yeah.
So I will obviously cover the.
Cover the cost of the deed.
Cover the cost of the deed.
No, that's quite cheap because the Quilio itself is worth about 380, so if you don't mind paying that, that'd be lovely.
And Stephen's ever such a nice horse, isn't he, Dickie?
I can call him and he can neigh back to me. I can go, Stephen! And he can go, just coming.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, Hazel get a bit lonely, though.
Well, Hazel's gone to glue, did I not tell you?
No, he's not.
No.
No, he's not. Wagon! Now, there are other wild horses about that he's quite friendly with. You know, I've sort of seen him, you know, neighing away at them. So, yeah, it's all good. And, you know, you could always, like, go and visit, can't you?
Yeah.
Take Stephen, you know, so they can keep in contact with each other.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Yeah. I'm sure Hazel's probably got a telegram number somewhere.
We're going straight on here.
Oh, okay. Oh, going a different way. Is this like the back passage, is it?
Yes, I thought I'd take you up the back passage rather than
northward. It's quite nice.
Oh.
Yeah, we'd have to go swamp fishing, won't we, the three of us?
Oh, yeah. And also, I got chatting to a very nice Irish man who told me that Ringneck Creek was very good for fishing. And I did get there and I got quite a lot of chain and redfin pickerel.
Is that the little tiny lake, isn't it? Block pond thing. Yeah, yeah. Be careful there. Because there's a lot of people go robbing people there.
Oh.
It's like a hot spot for being robbed. So you might want to avoid it.
Honestly, don't go there on my own.
Just go to my old spot. Honestly, you will not be like, you know, where's Dickie? He's there. No one will bother you at all.
Wait for Dickie.
He's there.
There we are. Yeah.
Yeah, that is like popular because apparently there is a legendary fish in there. So a lot of people do go there, and a lot of people do go there just to rob people because they're on their own.
Oh.
So, honestly, you know, I say my old spot is perfect because it's not far from the butcher's, not far from the bank. And if you're going to do like a couple of hours fishing and get loads of money, that's the best thing. The other place, you've got to, you know, travel about, haven't you, when you get too many fish? I know, it's nice.
Well, Ringneck Creek is actually quite close to road speed, I think.
Yeah, it's like literally Butcher. Just up the road,
yeah.
I think I might have to put my coat on.
But swamp fishing sounds fun.
Yeah. I've got to just put my coat on. That's better.
I think when I get my first paycheck from Abigail, I'm going to treat myself to a new outfit for special occasions.
Yeah.
Like, because if we're going to Dickie's premiere, I'm going to need something fancy for that.
Well, yeah, I'd probably like to get something a little bit more formal. Oh, yeah, better get money out, haven't we? Okay.
Yeah.
How much should we get out?
I got out 150, old boy. I just don't know how much it is.
Yeah, I'll do the same.
I'm hoping I win enough money to buy a new outfit for your premiere.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Dickie, I was thinking, you know, I'm going to sort of dress a bit more formal. What would you like me to wear?
What, for the proposal?
Yeah, for the opening night.
Oh, it's black.
Tuxedo.
Yes, that's it. That's the word.
You were struggling.
Well, that means I'm going to have to get a dress.
Yeah.
I'm not used to wearing dresses. I haven't worn a dress since my confirmation.
Where are you going?
Yeah, I haven't worn a dress since my confirmation.
Oh. Confirmation, what's that?
Oh, my daddy's Catholic. So my family's Catholic. Because he's Irish. So, when you're 12 or 13, you get dressed up in a pretty dress and you go to church and you get confirmed and they give you a special confirmation name, which is always Mary.
Like the Virgin?
Yeah.
Oh. So that's the last time you had a dress on when you was 12?
Yeah.
Oh, blimey.
And then you have a big party. You know, all your daddy and all your uncles get real drunk and start a fight.
Oh, blimey. Does it end up with a punch-up?
Yeah.
Where are we going?
Left here. Oh, no, a bit further on.
Oh, we're going near my shop.
Oh.
I'm calling my shop now.
Is this along here, is it your shop?
Yes, this is the Garden of Eden, I think. The restaurant is behind there. And then the shop is next to that. See?
Oh.
So just round here is the shop. It's my elixir shop.
Oh, it's very nice.
It's so pretty.
Yeah, very nice. Just going to tie up the horse. This is nice, isn't it?
I know, it's so beautiful.
Look at those lovely flowers, look.
Yeah, they're real pretty. And if you just look here.
Yeah. And a wasp.
Over there, Algernon Wasp, that's where I work.
Oh.
Hmm.
Where's Dickie gone? Oh, that looks nice. Like a sort of, what do you call it? An orangery, isn't it? They call that?
Oh, yeah.
It's lovely. Look at the stained glass up the top there.
Yeah, I know. The stained glass in there is absolutely stunning.
Yeah, oh, that looks ever so nice. Really, yeah, I'd like to check that out later before we go. Right, we're coming, Dickie. I was just looking at this nice shop.
No problem.
We're admiring the stained glass.
Right.
I'm taking the liberty of ordering a bottle of something and a little crab supper.
Oh.
Meal. And have you got space in your pocket, old boy, for your birthday present from old Dickie?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm excited for you.
Oh. Can I open it?
Yes, of course you can, old boy.
Oh, thank you. Dickie, that's beautiful.
Yes, that pocket watch belonged to my father, you see.
Oh, Dick.
And he gave it to me on his 19th birthday, on my 19th birthday, not his. And now I bequeath it upon you.
It's real kind, huh?
Thank you, Dickie.
Oh, bring it in.
Let's have some noise.
Yes.
You knew he'd cry.
Yes. Knew you'd sob like a little baby.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, sorry. Oh, thank you so much. That's beautiful.
Yes. It's yours now, old boy. Look after it.
Oh, Shell. Thank you.
Yes. Another thing to put in your storage box.
Yeah. Yeah, that's lovely. Thank you. Look at it, Dickie.
Wow.
It's gold. Yes. It's so beautiful.
Yes. I tend to accidentally sit on it to make sure I'm on time. Do you get it?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's lovely.
Here,
thank you so much, Dickie.
Yes, you're welcome.
I shall treasure that for the rest of my life. And then when I have, like, children, I'll give it to my first child on his 19th birthday.
Yes. Anybody want a little drop of... Vino. I believe it's a Merlot.
Oh, yeah, I'll have a little drop of wine.
I'll take a glass of it.
Where shall I sit?
Wherever you want to sit. You're the birthday boy.
I'll sit here and then we can all sit come and sit round this side, Dickie, and we're all together then, aren't we?
Where am I sitting?
Just next to me.
Oh, yes. Well, the crab looks delicious.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very nice.
Amazing.
Yeah. Oh, look at those lovely plants round here, Dickie. It's like we're not in paradise or somewhere.
Well, we are, old boy.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, no, I miss a chair.
Oh dear, too much wine already.
Wine went straight to my head as I'm drinking.
One sip and she's anybody's.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, this is pleasant, isn't it?
It's lovely, yeah. You're right there, Flo. Would you like me to help you sit down?
Oh, yes, please.
See that chair? It's just got like a bit of a lot of slash on the back there. Just try that and then sit on it.
There you go. He's better here.
Yeah. Oh, this is lovely.
Yes, this is the Garden of Eden.
Yes, a pun. The Garden of Eden.
Oh, yes, I get it now. Did the owner, Lydia, have you met her, Flo?
Yes, I have. She's a good friends with Agrigal, who I work for. And she was very nice. She said to me if I needed anything to just ask.
Oh, what a bitch. And I'll tell you for why. Because I wrote to her when I first got here and I was trying to compile my recipe book. And I wrote to her and she never got back to me. So one day I marched myself up here and she was here. I said, I wrote to you about recipes. And she said, well, why don't you try out different recipes? And I said, why would I want to try it out when I could just give you $50 and you can tell me? And she said, no.
Some people are very protective of it, aren't they? Like that. There was a lady once in Blackwater working behind the bar. And she was like selling peach cobbler, I think it was. And I said, you know, my friend is he's trying to get recipes together. Could I buy the recipe off you? And she was like, was really adamant and said, no, that was my mother's and you're not having it. And pointed at me quite like violently and smiled as she did it, which I thought was a bit strange. Do you remember that, Dickie?
I do.
The telegram office, wasn't it, in Blackwater?
Yes, we were there, yes. Do you know what I do, just to spite those people? What? If I meet somebody new, I say, here, have a look at my book. There's loads of recipes in here, absolutely free of charge.
Oh.
Bugged that.
Yeah.
I know
people are like that about their Italianics as well. They're very, you know, all the recipes I have had to just try and guess them all, and it's a lot of work.
Yes. Mm. I guess, I think what they're trying to do is, you know, make it exciting for you, but when I want a peach cobbler, I want a peach cobbler.
Yeah, it does get quite frustrating, yeah.
Yes.
Cider wine is ever so nice.
Yes, is it a Merlot?
Yeah, I think so. Well, I'm not a connoisseur, but yes. It tastes like red wine to me.
Oh, yes. Might be a Rioja. Yes, that's how they pronounce it in Spain.
Yeah, was it a ricotta, they call it, or is that something else?
That's a cheese.
Oh, right, yeah.
Oh, Rihanna.
Do you not like it, Flo? Is it a little bit
tart for you? It's a bit for tart you? For me, yeah. I'm more of a beer drinker.
Do you like it, Dickie?
Well, I think it might be a Rioja, you know.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Spanish wine.
Oh, Rio.
Rioja, yes.
It's nicer on the second sip.
Yes. Not too much, though, old boy. You remember what happened last time you had tobacco?
Yeah, and I'm riding as well, so I must be careful. Well, you know, not just my life at risk, it's Flo's, isn't it? So.
Oh, but it's your birthday. You drink as much as you like.
Yeah, I've never had.
Know?
Yeah, well, I will, you know, perhaps in the casino I might have a proper beer.
Yeah.
Well, how's the crab, Dickie? I've never had crab.
Yes. Well, you can't eat the shell, old boy. You've got to sort of break it open. It's nice with a little spot of lemon.
Oh, I'll try that.
Do you want my crab?
What, are you not like... Oh, no, it's got a face in it.
Yeah. His little beady eyes are looking up at me.
Oh, yes. When I booked the place, I forgot about it. I can feel judging
me from the plate.
Why don't you have a bread roll?
Yeah, I love bread. I could just live on bread. I want to learn to bake some bread.
It's quite tasty, ain't it?
Mm.
Yes.
Never had crab before.
Yes. It's like a more meaty fish.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's exquisite. With the bread recipe, Flo, I don't know if it's just water, flour, salt, maybe.
Possibly, yeah.
Flatbread sort of thing. I'm not sure. I might have to give it a go.
Mm. Oh, I think I will. You could make a nice flatbread in a frying pan, I would have thought.
Yes.
So, are most ingredients for all these sort of recipes just you can buy them in a general store, or do you have to actually go out and forage for them?
Well, the potatoes. Yeah,
potatoes I had to dig.
Yes. Dig them up, didn't we?
That's why I bought the shovel, so I could make you the scalloped potatoes.
Oh, you could have borrowed my shovel.
I will.
I was just thinking, perhaps, we'll buy a box and go to the general store and get a load of, different ingredients and see what we can...
Oh, have a cooking man.
Yeah.
Yeah. That sounds fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. We've got lots of activities planned with the treasure hunt as well. That sounds very exciting.
Yeah.
Flo's not been treasure hunting before, so we must take...
No, I have not.
Who's that? Is that just a local?
No idea. It's not a normal road back there. I think it's just somebody.
They seem to be
in a hurry.
Going a bit back and forth, though.
Yeah, it's a bit wibbly-wobbly.
Maybe
the wine.
Oh, yes, might be the wine.
Yeah. It's quite an effect on you, doesn't it? Even just a couple of sips.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Yeah, I mean, I've got some recipes. I've got the ones that you gave me, Dickie.
Oh, yes.
So how many recipes are there then? Is it just like loads and loads where you can find out?
Well, somebody gave me some cornbread the other day that they'd made.
Oh, yeah, I think that's what needs the buttermilk. I'm sure I heard someone say that.
Yes, so I think that's probably a bit of corn, milk, buttermilk, flour, and maybe a bit of salt or something, I don't know, or sugar, maybe, who knows.
Looks like that rider's scouting about over there.
Where?
Just right in front of you, see him? Or is that just his horse? No, it's just his horse.
Now, where's the person gone then?
I don't know. The horse seems to be
saw them get off the horse at that big house over there.
Right. Do you know who lives there?
No.
The one right at the very end is the Moretti family.
Oh.
Oh, I'm not standing on the table. I did not stand in my plate of crab.
Oh, dear.
No.
Yes, I don't know. I don't know who that was. But yes, the Moretti family live at the end. I've been in that house, you know.
Have you?
Yes.
Well, is it nice?
Oh, it's absolutely exquisite. Yes, they are. Well, it's, I went upstairs onto the sort of landing, if you call it that, and had coffee with the wife of the man.
Moretti? Is that Amadeo? I met him.
Yes, Amadeus Moretti. I met his late wife, yes. She wasn't late when I met her. She died later.
Oh, was it something you said?
No. Well, she was meant to be in my play, you see. She was the first person that got cast, and then...
Was that Betty Spaghetti?
Yes, Betty Moretti.
Oh, right. Oh, see, I met Amadeo Moretti and someone called Norman on my way from Rhodes once.
Norman?
And they just started talking to me on the road. And I got scared because I thought they were going to rob me. But they were just very nice, actually. They said, oh, you're a pharmacist. You must be very clever. And I said, well, I know a lot about pharmacy. And then I think Norman gave me his telegram number and said, if ever you need anything, give me a shout.
Oh, that's lovely.
Is that not the same Norman that's the understudy, is it?
No, this one was Scottish.
Oh.
Oh, I know Norman. He's come to Drama Club a couple of times.
Oh.
Yes, no, he came once. Didn't really engage. Never came back.
Ah. Well, he's good friends with that Amadeo Spaghetti.
Oh, yes. And the little street rat named Elio, who's a wonderful little young boy. You met him, Rodney. He's adopted by the Moretti family as well.
Oh, right. Mm. So, is there more than like two Italian families here then?
Yeah, there is two.
Right. Ah, so.
The Dickensos.
Yes.
Yeah. And the Morettis.
Yes, but I don't know all of it because, I'd keep my nose out of it. Mm-hmm. But I believe they get on quite amicably.
Oh, that's nice.
Is there another family called the Peronis?
Don't think so. Well, mind you, there's some the Mamma Mia people. Now, what are they called? The people that own the Bastille.
There's a lady called Naomi Angeli. When I was first in town, she was advertising for people to work there.
Oh, yes, I know Naomi. She owns the theatre, the cinematography projection place.
Oh.
I think it's just called cinema.
And she didn't know a cinematographer.
Well, I wrote to her, but she never responded, so I assume she's dead. Oh. And I've not seen her for weeks and weeks.
Why do so many people not respond to you?
Maybe they're intimidated by me, I don't know.
Starstruck, I reckon.
Did you know that some of the people that come to the theatre club think that I'm intimidating?
Oh, really?
I was told, yes.
Yeah.
Oh. I said, shut up! You need to get to know me first.
Yeah, that would learn them.
Mac asked me if you were really a sir.
Who?
Mac, you know, my daddy's friend.
Yes.
Asked me if you were a genuine sir, a knight of the realm.
Yes.
How did you get your knighthood?
Are you asking me or is Mac asking me?
I'm asking you, actually.
Yes, when I worked with the Garrick Theatre in London, we used to put on shows, and the money that we used, we invested into the community, educated some of the little scallywag children, you know, brought them into the theatre and taught them not just theatre, but, you know, communication, manners, how to speak the Queen's English, and, yes, and... Queen Victoria, God rest her troubled soul, wrote to me and she said, "Oh, Dickie, old boy, you must come to the palace and receive your knighthood."
Oh.
And was she amused?
Was she what?
Amused.
Well, she, no.
Because she's normally not amused. It's not what she says. I read that in the newspaper.
Yes. Oh, she said I was very amusing.
Oh.
Yes.
I know she's into Prince Albert's.
Yes. Well, she's dead now, old boy. Girl.
Yeah. Oh, of course she is, yeah. But that was really very philanthropic of you.
Yes. Well, that's why I got it. They don't give out these knighthoods just for being a wonderful actor in Richard II.
Don't give them out willy-nilly.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I wasn't the first actor to get a knighthood. The other one was John the...
John who?
The
oh.
Virgo.
Yes.
Who's he?
He owned the theatre that was called... It's called...
The Crucible.
No.
The Green Beige.
The Lyceum Theatre.
Oh, yeah.
It was Henry Irving, that was it. He got the knighthood, not John Virgo. Yes. It's all coming back to me now.
Yeah. So did Queen get a lot of big sword out when she knighted you?
Oh, yeah, she whipped it out and said, "Get on your knees, Dickie, old boy."
Oh.
Oh, was it quite the knee trembler for you?
Oh, yes. And she rested it on my shoulder. And she said, "Arise, Sir Dickie."
Did you get up?
It must have been quite hard for you to arise at your age.
Yes, it was quite.
You did stand to attention.
No, I did. I gave her the full salute.
Stood up erect.
Gave her the full salute, but then you can't turn your back on her, you see?
Oh, nice. She could have whipped the sword off you, you know, whipped your head off with her sword.
Mm. Yes.
Giving you a brace.
Yes. So one of the old knees was starting to go, so I was sort of a bit crouched, still in a sort of forward position, bowing my head whilst walking backwards. Oh dear, that's the last thing she saw of me.
Yeah, he's all like bent over, weren't you? Hunched.
Yes. Yes. So, yes, I took that back to the Garrick and showed everyone, said, "Cast your bug-eyed stare rods at my medal."
Your medal?
Yeah, it was a little cross thingamajig. Oh, said again.
That's nice.
Yes. Right. I feel like I want to go and blow $150 on a game.
Yeah,
I
don't wish you'd be sitting with this money on us for too long.
I do need to have a tinkle.
Oh, yes.
Where's the best place to have a tinkle? Oh, I'm on a table. Look out.
Over the wall there, old boy, but watch out for the crocodiles.
Oh, God, really? Would I be able to get back over if I jump over here?
Just do it there in the flower bed.
Okay.
I'll turn the other way.
I sort of look like a dirty Humpty Dumpty.
I do worry that your John Thomas is above the wall lines. Anyone who's looking out of their window, those big houses.
Well, it's just below the post thing here. It's like a little column thing here.
Oh, right.
Yeah. I'll, don't talk to me because I'll get stage fright. It's lovely here, ain't it? It's really nice. It's a really nice garden.
Also, what's really good about the tonics and stuff is you can get water from this fountain too.
Oh, yeah. I need to fill up my canteen, actually.
Yeah, me too.
Do you need to fill up yours, Dickie? I've still got like an image in my mind of Dickie hunched over with a strained look on his face.
Oh dear, you might need some bleach for that.
Yeah.
What's that?
I said I've got this, still got this image of you hunched over with a strained look on your face.
Oh yes.
Oh, it's lovely.
Like this. Like this, and then having to sort of back out slowly.
Oh, right. Dear.
Yeah, like some sort of cave creature.
Yeah. Oh, this is exquisite.
Oh, this is a lovely shop, Flo.
Look at the stained glass windows.
Oh, and the hanging baskets. And you've got a fan.
And there's a fan.
Yeah. How does that work?
And tea. Oh,
that's beautiful. Yeah, look at those hats, Dickie. Honestly, if you wore one of those, you know, one of your stage acts, I mean, that would be fantastic. You'd look sensational.
Yeah.
You think?
Yeah.
Huh. And a corset.
Oh, yeah.
Well, yeah.
That fit me.
And look at that. Is it? I think there's a phonograph. Plays music.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Look at that.
Beautiful.
All the modern conventions.
It's lovely. What is these photos over here?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe paintings. They're Abigail's family.
There. Lovely.
She looks a bit like my mother.
Ah.
There's a fella there wearing tights.
Yeah, I can see that he's got quite the moose knuckle on display.
It's got something there. Maybe a hernia.
Yes, should we go and throw our money away?
Yeah, come on, let's go before we get it pinched off of us. Oh, it's lovely, Flo. I'm really glad you got a nice place to work.
Yeah, I'm real happy about that.
Yeah, do you get many customers, do you?
Oh, well, I haven't started yet.
Oh,
so
right.
I've got to do the herb bedroom first.
Right. When do you actually start? As soon as you've got your herbs?
Yeah, as soon as I've got all the time for her. And then, yeah, she said I can just turn up in the shop and work when I want.
Well, that's good.
As long as I've gathered all the herbs she needs, then I can spend as long as I want working in there. And she just pays me for the herbs, and then I make just a little commission
on
anything I sell.
That's perfect. That's just the sort of job you're looking for, ain't it? Because I know you don't want to do like rangering or, you know, do like any medical stuff, but...
No, the paperwork and the interruptions to my day.
Yeah.
I like being free with my time.
Yeah. I must admit, since being a ranger, I just hardly have any time for myself. It's just all go.
Yeah.
I must say, I do appreciate that you dedicate time to spend with us, you know.
No, you're my best friend, so...
Oh.
You know, I'm not going to let you, you know, let both of you down by not seeing you. I like seeing you. I like doing stuff together. It's fun. Always have a giggle.
We do.
Yeah.
And an adventure.
Yeah. One of the lady rangers said that she wants to come fishing, so I'll have to invite her along.
Yeah, that'll be good.
Yeah, and then you've got like a female friend then, haven't you, Flo?
Yeah. And I do like fishing.
Yeah, we all like fishing.
I never thought I would get into that. But you taught me very well, and now I can catch some real good fish.
Oh, that's good, yeah. Honestly, it's a great way to make money, it's the bob.
Yeah.
I believe that it's the best way to make money. You know, sod all that, you know, mining or doing orange runs. You know, just get yourself a good rod, get down to some water and fish like mad.
And it's so relaxing.
Yeah, get a nice spot and you've got nice scenery and it's perfect.
Yeah, I quite like it in the swamp because I quite enjoy the sounds of the swamp. The crickets.
I'm a bit worried about the, alligators, isn't it?
Gators, yeah, I nearly got my foot bitten by one.
Oh, God.
It was very scary. I accidentally stepped on its tail and it went to snip at me.
Really? Oh, my God.
And I just ran so fast.
Shall we go down this way and go along, Dickie?
Yeah, just around here.
Yeah, well, I think if we go swamp fishing together, what with swamp lures, we'll see what we pull out, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's nice to fish for something different in a different area.
Yeah. Well, I can't remember where I was, but I got a real huge lake sturgeon. And you know what? It was not worth that much.
Oh, no.
It was gigantic.
It's ridiculous, isn't it? These really big fish, they're just... Perhaps they don't taste very nice.
Yeah.
I mean, didn't we try some, Dickie? Or was that another fish that we had? I think it was another fish, wasn't it?
Maybe they're all blubber and no meat.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think it's through here, yes, here.
Oh, yeah, look at it. Got great big, like, chimney things on it.
Wow. Oh. I've never been on this boat.
No, I've never been, like, really down this part of St. Denis. Where are we going to put the horses, Dickie?
Here. Right here.
Will they be safe here?
I don't know. Hopefully, I won't wander too far. I'm going to put this watch on my horse, Dickie.
Oh, yes.
That's far too precious.
Yeah.
Oh, what's that you're eating, Dickie?
That was the chocolate milk.
Oh, yeah.
Yes,
I've still got more, if you need any more, anybody.
I haven't had my first one yet. I drank all that wine.
Step aboard.
Go on, Flo, after you. Go on, Dickie, after you.
After you, birthday boy.
Thank you.
Where do we go now? Do we go up the steps?
Yeah. After you, Flo. Oh, look at it in here.
Wow, these
are chandeliers. Oh no, it's all the gold everywhere. Look, there's people down here at the tables.
Oh my goodness. You know, I do live in fear of a chandelier shard dropping off and just like stabbing me in the face.
Well, don't stand underneath one then.
I mean, it'd be quite a decadent way to die, I guess.
Yeah. It'd be an unusual way to die.
I would feel quite bourgeois.
Yeah, like Miss Bourgeois.
Oh, yeah.
Well, might as well give it a go.
Oh, I don't really know what I have to do, but I'll have a go.
£20 to buy in, is it? Minimum, right?
Yes.
It's quite expensive.
Yes.
Right.
Then you open it up, I think. Open your eyes up and then you see it.
Open bit.
Yeah.
But
I suppose you can either bet red or black.
Oh.
Or one of the numbers, or like 1 to 18, I think.
Oh, yeah. I think I'm going to bet black to $5. Yes. $5, all on, no, on for it to be black.
I've gone $5 red.
Oh.
And in that way, but one of us will win, won't they?
Yes. What have you gone for, Flo?
I've gone $5 black.
Oh, you like it? No, I had a good seam.
Oh, the ball's rolling.
Oh. What's it on?
I don't know, I can't see.
I can't see.
It's going too fast.
What's it on?
Black! Yeah. I won $5.
Oh,
Rodney.
Yeah, I should have stuck with you, shouldn't I? Got out
the
boat.
Yeah, I was just copying Dickie because...
you didn't really know what you was doing, did you?
No, I had no clue.
No.
Right, I'm going to put... oh, dear. I'm going to put it on even. $5 on even.
I'm going even as well.
Oh, I've gone 1 to 18, $5.
I've gone $5 even like Dickie. Hopefully Dickie's like lucky tonight.
Yeah, lucky Dickie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or you can pick a specific number and colour. That must be high risk, wasn't it?
Yeah, but I reckon you get a lot of money if it comes in.
Yeah. Did I make my bet? I think I did.
I don't know, did you?
Says I got $20, so I must have bet $5.
Yeah.
Come on, even.
1 to 18, come on. He keeps coughing all over the roulette bowl.
Oh, no, I think he's got like some sort of disease. Oh, I won a fiver.
Yeah,
we all won $5. Yeah. Oh, that's good. I'm back to my $20 now. That's good.
Yeah. I'm up 10 on the deal. Everything on black 29.
Oh.
No, I can't.
I've gone $5 on 1 to 18.
I'm going to go $5 on odd.
Oh.
No. I'm going to go $5 on third 12.
Oh, I've gone $5 on 19 to 36.
Yeah, what's that? Oh, okay. Third 12. Oh, I'm scared. I don't want to do it.
What's 2 to 1 then? On the bottom of the
thing. Oh, is it double your money? I don't know.
Oh.
Oh, no, it's the first column, so it's 1. Oh.
4, 7, 10, 13.
Ah,
right.
Oh.
No, I didn't bet.
Oh, Dickie.
I didn't realise he was going to spin it.
I was watching him cough. We should have done this ages ago, shouldn't we, come here?
Well, you might have got a gambling addiction now and got real poor.
Oh, it finished in the zero.
Oh, I lost $5.
Oh.
What should I do? Second column, $25.
Oh. Can you put 25 on then?
Yes. You just have to have the 25, old boy.
Right.
Well, I've gone for the third column.
I've gone for the first.
$5.
Oh, dear.
I've put all my money on.
On the first one? How much money did you have?
I think I just put 25 on there.
Oh, dear. I put 25 on the second column. Someone's going to be very disappointed.
Yeah.
did you bet on Flo, the third column?
Yeah, but I only bet $5.
Oh, good luck, everybody.
Good luck. Here he goes. He's got his hands on the ball. I think he's just picked his nose. Did you see that?
What is it?
Second column.
Oh, yes.
Was that you, Dickie, with the second column?
Oh, yes, old boy.
How much do you win?
Well, I'm up to $80 for a $20 buy-in.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my. I'm at $20. What about you, Rodney?
How do I put more money in?
When you select the thing you want, they ask you.
Right.
The gentleman asks you, yes. I'm too scared to bet any money now.
Well, you're up, aren't you?
Yes, I think I'll sit out this one, old boy.
Oh, I've just gone easy and just bet on black.
I've gone 25 on red.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no, I've gone mental.
Yeah. Oh dear.
Good
so
luck.
What do you want, Flo? What did you bet on? Black.
Black, $5. I'm a very cautious gambler.
Yeah.
Rodney, you've got all of it on red.
Yeah, $25. I've won $25.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, I'm sort of back up a bit now.
Yeah.
Should we try another table?
Yes. Oh, God, what's this?
Come and have a look at this one, Flo. What? Come? It's got come on the table.
What? Oh, dear.
And the horn. So if you get the horn, do you come?
Oh, my goodness, this is a very... Strange table.
Yeah.
I have absolutely no idea what this is all about.
I'm just joining with 20 quid. I don't know what it is.
The term crepes.
Yeah. Make your best.
Oh, God. What do I do? I'm going to sit out. Point is six. What are you talking about, old boy?
I don't know. I think you've got to roll a six.
Oh,
I think it's all like you've got
I have no idea.
Guess what dice you're going to roll.
I need to take a comfort break. Excuse me.
Okay. Hello.
I have no idea what I'm doing. Huh? Oh, this is very confusing. I'm real confused.
I've gone for the horn. $5.
Oh, I don't want to risk $20 on something that I don't have a clue what I'm even doing. Did you win?
No. I don't really know this one.
No, this one's... utterly confusing.
I've gone double three. $5.
Double three.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
Make him win, sir. It's his birthday. Six. He's 19. You should be giving him odds of 19-1 on every bet.
Yeah, should do.
Yeah.
No, I don't like this game much.
It's his birthday. Come on.
Yeah, I'm
give him money.
Yeah, I prefer the one with the wheel thing. Mm. What's this one up here? Oh, it's another roulette, isn't it? Is that all they got here? They got any card games?
Yeah, I thought they would have
Is it upstairs, maybe?
I don't know. Where's Dickie gone?
Oh, he went for a comfort break. So I think he's gone to the little boy's room, yeah.
Come and have a drink. Let's have a drink. Oh, there he is. Yeah, I don't like that crabs.
Drinks are on me.
Oh, let me... You sure? I don't mind buying you one.
Well, I'm up on the deal, aren't I, old boy? What do you want?
There's some cigarettes on the bar, Dickie. Should I get them for you? Because you know you've got ever so sticky fingers.
Yes, please. What do you want, old boy? What do you want, Flair?
I'll have a beer.
I will also take a beer, please. Thank you.
A real beer, Rodney?
Yeah.
Oh, dear. I think I'll have a scotch.
God.
Ladies first.
Yeah.
One beer.
Thank you so much.
One beer for you. Oh, thank you, Omar.
Thank you. Right. Do you think it'll go wibbly wobbly?
Absolutely, old boy.
Cheers. Are you having a drink, Flo?
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh. It's a little... Oh. It is a bit wibbly wobbly.
Are you going on,
Wolsey? Yeah, it's not as bad as the whiskey we had that time when we ended up throwing up everywhere.
Yeah, well, I only threw up because you threw up, old boy.
Yeah. Oh, that makes it even more wibbly wobbly.
Yes.
Oh, dear. What are you drinking, Scotch?
Oh, yeah.
And you've got a proper beer, Rodney?
Yeah, it's all a bit wibbly wobbly.
Oh, yeah. I'm very wibbly wobbly now.
Oh, yes. I'm the most wibbliest and the wobbliest.
Oh, God, yeah. Look down at the room, the stairs at the other end. It's all very wibbly wobbly.
Oh, dear.
Don't wander off. No.
Yeah, I don't want you falling over the side.
No. Mm. And we can play roulette again.
It'd be very embarrassing getting the rangers out to rescue you.
Oh, look at the table. It's like I'm off me tits. It's moving away, the table, look. Stretching. Contracting.
Are you sure you didn't get a Babylite mushroom in with it?
I don't think so. I do feel like very strange.
I'm putting 200 on red.
Oh my God!
Oh.
Let me join.
I don't know how to.
I'm trying. I'll put $50 in.
Oh my God, I've put 200 on.
You mad, mad Dickie. Well, I love you.
I love you.
I'm going to go black.
We're sweet together.
Yeah.
$25 black.
Oh God, I hope it's red, old boy. What have I done for $200 on it?
You've got how are you supposed to do that? I just can't do more than 25.
Just keep on the 25s.
Yeah, look at that, it's all spinning.
Come on, blue red. Do it for Dickie.
Go on, Dickie, I hope you win it.
I hope I win.
Yeah, you deserve it. I won 25.
Oh, congratulations.
Oh, Dickie, you lost. Was that all your money gone?
Dickie. Excuse me for one moment.
No, don't, Dickie, come back. He's not going to...
Is he all right?
Let's go and find him. Oh, Dickie. Oh, I feel much better now. Dickie!
$200, old boy.
Oh, Dickie. But it is my birthday.
Yes. Well done, old boy. You won $25.
Yeah.
Congratulations. I won $5.
Oh, well done. No, I don't want that.
Go on, Dickie, because otherwise we have to go home early.
That's true. No, I don't. Well, we should probably be heading to Strawberry anyway, shouldn't we?
What are we doing, Strawberry?
Oh, what is it? Drinks
with the Rangers, won't
we? Oh, yeah.
Do you still want to do that?
Yeah, yeah. There might be more people about now.
Yeah. Is there a carriage we can hire?
Oh, yeah. Should we do that? I'll buy it, because I've got the money.
I can put towards it.
I'm $30 up.
Well done.
Yeah.
I'll buy it. Where do we get a carriage? Do you know?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yes, I know. It's on the way out towards the roads.
Oh, right. Look at the smoke around the chandeliers.
Oh, yes. Are you feeling a bit better now?
Yeah, yeah. I don't feel like I'm all wibbly wobbly.
Oh, look at that painting.
There's a naked.
There's a naked.
Is it a fella, isn't it? Yeah.
Child. Maybe we should go.
Yeah, yeah. Don't want that reputation going around.
No.
Oh, it's night time.
We should probably report them for having nonce paintings.
Most definitely nonce. Yeah. Do you want to walk to the carriage or take the horses?
Let's take the horses and then we can let them run off, can't we?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was fun. I didn't really understand what we were doing.
No, I didn't. I mean, maybe roulette was probably a bit easier than the whatever the craps was. But
yeah. Maybe like blackjack or something, Dickie. What do you reckon?
Yeah.
I'd
have to try that, wouldn't we?
Hmm.
Although I have heard that game is proper rigged by the banker.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think I've ever really won anything on that kind of thing.
Yeah. Do you know how much a carriage is, Dickie?
$25, $50, something like that.
Can we go to the bank quickly?
Yeah. Yeah, I need to put some of my money in the bank.
Yeah.
And I'll give you some towards the carriage.
No, don't be silly. I've got loads of money.
I hear your ranger get paid well now, don't you?
I do, yeah. Dickie, I'm sad for you.
Oh, I'm not at all. I knew what I was doing, old boy.
Well, it would have been nice if it came in. Maybe next time, eh?
Yes, maybe next time. I've got $200 to throw.
Yeah, well, when it's your birthday, eh?
Yes.
Yeah, and depending on how old you are, then ranger cat will give you that amount of dollars.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. When's it your birthday, Flo?
Oh, 3rd of June.
All right, so you got one coming up next then.
Yeah, I'll be 23.
Well, yeah, that's not too far away. I'll have to do something for your birthday.
Yeah, that'd be nice, yeah.
I'll have to think of something that I want to do.
Yeah, sounds good. I might have that scarlet potato thing.
Oh, yeah. Let me know how it is.
Oh, that's ever so nice.
Oh, I think anything with potatoes in is nice, so.
Yeah, it's got all nice crispy, cheesy bits on top.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Bread and potatoes. You can't go wrong with bread or potatoes.
Do you want to try a bit, Dickie? I'll spoon a bit in your mouth.
Oh, yes, pop it in, old boy.
Ready?
Yes. Nom, nom.
It's creamy, isn't it?
Oh, would you like to try a bit, Flo? We've all shared the spoon. There you go. What was that like?
Oh, that was delicious, actually, yeah. Even if I do say so myself.
I gave you a lot of crispy bit.
Yeah, lovely.
Oh, very nice.
That's delicious. You don't need the pan back, do you?
No.
No, that's all right. I'll leave it in here for someone to trip over. They might stand on it and go skidding. Right then, let's go and get on a carriage. Are you going to drive, Dickie? Because you know what my carriage driving's like.
Yes, if you want me to, old boy, I'll drive it.
Yes, please. Are we going to have like an open air one like the royal family has?
I don't know. You can pick whatever one you like. You're paying.
Well, I'll give you the money and you can get it.
Okay. I saw Scrum Toggins down by the telegram office, but I chose to ignore him.
He didn't turn up, did he?
No, that's somebody else. I don't mix business with pleasure. Yes.
No, I see. Did you want to go and say hello to him, or
no.
Would you rather not?
I'd rather not.
Right, okay.
I'll see him tomorrow for rehearsals anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, I've got to do rangery stuff tomorrow. What are you doing tomorrow, Flo? Working?
I'm working. I'm going to get all that time for Abigail.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, Flo, I'm free up until 10 p.m. old money, so...
That's good.
Why not to come out and go
That would be nice.
Is it here? Is it Dickie?
Yes, it's just here.
Oh, right. I always wonder where you could get the coaches from.
I'll just go and give him some money. Oh, blimey. Monty nearly had us on the floor. Here, Dickie, here's some money.
Oh, yes.
Are you as good a coach driver as you are a boat driver?
Yes. Thank you.
No problem.
Right.
I'll just let Moonshadow go. Right, Moonshadow, I want you to head back to Strawberry, please.
Night, Moonshadow. See you in Strawberry.
Off he goes.
Bye, Moonshadow.
Oh.
Look, he's like gone through the park.
Yeah. I think he's taking a shortcut.
Yeah. Probably dipping his hoofs in the water.
Oh, yeah, he likes that. Keeps his. On. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Where's Dickie? Oh, he's over there. Well, have they got anything nice and fancy?
Yes, I'm going to go with this one, I think, because it's close for you too, and I'll ride up front, but we can still talk through the glass.
Yeah. I think you've got to get on first.
Oh, look at the lanterns on
there. I know, it reminds me a lot of the ones you get in like London, like a London cab, isn't it?
Yeah.
They're quite flammable, those, aren't they?
Yeah. Mm. Right, off to you, Flo. Oh, no, I don't want to get up here.
Oh, thank you.
Let me come round this side. See if I can get in here.
None taken, old boy.
Here we are. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. We might be getting a good view of Dickie's butt, though.
Yeah. If you sort of...
When he gets up to crack the whip.
Yeah, if you view it, you'll be able to see it even better.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's an excellent driver.
He is.
Go, Dickie, go.
Yeah. I shall.
How much did it cost to get this one? $50?
40 I pocketed the other 10.
That's perfectly okay.
It's a driver tax.
Yeah, that's your pay for taking us all the way to Strawberry.
Oh my god, the thunderstorms. Good thing we did get the carriage.
Oh yes. Yeah. Wonderfully lucky.
Would you like my coat wrapped across your legs?
Thank you. Just as we came off the bridge there was a lot of people in the front yard of that warehouse.
Oh, really?
About 10 people stood there.
Oh, ruffians, I reckon.
On the warehouse? Yeah. The workers?
Ruffians.
Yes. Oh, lovely, the rain's coming down now. They're both comfortable.
It's ever so nice in here. The seat's quite comfy.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Home, James. I've always wanted to say that. Dicker, yeah. Oh.
I hope I don't run into anybody I know. How embarrassing for me.
Well, you just have to talk in a foreign language and then they won't know it's you.
Okay.
Give us an example of a foreign language.
No.
But they're just going to know it's you, isn't it, if you just speak like normal.
Or just tell them you don't go south for the river at this time of night.
Yeah.
Off my
I was just about to say it's absolutely pissed it down, Dickie.
Yes, it is. Right.
Yeah, you might have to slow down in town, Dickie, otherwise you get a fine. Remember, sorry, Flo, cutting you off there.
Oh, that's alright, but yeah, it's better that you
said that. This is wonderfully exciting.
Yeah. Oh, what a birthday.
Yeah, it's been great. Thank you to both of you for making it lovely.
Well, it was all Dickie's idea.
Yeah, Dickie's like, you know, my Uncle Dickie. Look, there's more ruffians.
Rhodes is full of ruffians tonight.
Yeah.
Oh.
You alright, Dickie?
Huh? You got cream?
Oh. Just the rain was wiping it out of my eyes, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have the same style of hair, and I do find that this hair is pretty good for keeping the rain off, though. The yes, nice wide brim.
Thank you for your input.
We have very good taste in hats.
Yeah. This is great fun, Dickie.
Oh, the best fun I've had. $200 down, soaking wet. Lovely birthday for you.
Let's hope your birthday's a lot better.
Yeah.
Honestly, you drive that like, you know, you've done that so many times.
Yeah.
You sure you weren't a cab driver in London?
Quiet.
Yeah.
Sorry, just having a little bit of difficulty. There we go. Up the hill, you stupid thing.
Yeah, the horse needs to go a little bit, you know, more steady, doesn't
he? Yeah. Cool.
No, oh, that's bumpy.
Imagine these roads are ever so bumpy.
Yeah.
They really should do something about the roads.
Yeah. Perhaps they should put like cobble.
Out the way.
Go, Dickie's got his gun out. Go, go, go.
Oh, dear.
Go.
Is that the local?
Carriages yeah. Have the right of way, surely.
Let's hope we don't get on his horse and chase us.
Oh, no.
I might have to shoot him. I don't know. You know, it's not really what you're supposed to do as a ranger.
Yeah, but you're supposed to protect the citizens, right?
Yeah, I'm protecting the citizens, yeah.
Yes, by committing murder.
The greater good.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, you wouldn't want that person to live over on Dickie, would you?
No.
No. Think of the last of the crowd scene.
Yeah. What happens if we come across wolves?
Well, what's this? The road just stops here. Why do I always do this?
I don't know. You're supposed to go up to your right, but you can go along this way.
Oh, go over here somewhere. Wolves, I tell you what'll happen. I'll get eaten and you'll be perfectly safe.
No, I don't think they'd be able to jump up. You'd just be able to sit there and, like, you know. I think I could probably get my gun out.
Poke it out the window.
No.
I've got a hammer. If they get near me, I will absolutely bludgeon them with this hammer.
I'll just jump out and absolutely fuck them up. Oh, pardon my potty mouth.
Where the bloody hell are we?
I don't know. Just don't go over the cliffs.
Get
out of the way.
Oh. Yeah, I think you just got to make one, haven't you?
I think we must be near a flat next station because I can see that. That tall thing just back there.
Yeah, this is, coming up to Bard's Crossing.
Oh, yeah. I've yet to go fishing here.
Yeah. It's good for trout.
Yeah. Yeah, I've never caught a trout.
Maybe try the crayfish as bait. That might catch the old trout.
Oh, I caught pickerel with corn.
Oh.
No, not corn, bread. Right. Ringneck Creek. And I caught chain pickerel with cheese.
Oh. That's interesting. I should have to make a note of that for my ranger project. We saw a coach, didn't we, Dickie, that had been abandoned in the water.
Really?
Yeah. Someone had gone in too deep, and then
it
was just there, and we thought everybody drowned.
Oh no.
Yeah, we couldn't find any bodies though.
No.
When was he?
It's a couple of days ago, wasn't it, Dickie? I think.
Oh, yeah, I think over a week ago now.
Was it a week ago? Oh, honestly, all the days just seem to merge into one.
They do, don't they?
They do.
Even your so fast.
Yeah, I was just about to say, even your birthday party years of time has just flown by.
It has, yeah. It's been
Now that you're older, Rodney, that time's going to go even faster now.
Yeah, well, I'll be able to look at the watch, won't I? Like the clock thing, pocket watch, and see time go by. Are you going to pull up outside the ranger station and I can, jump out and go, hello, everybody?
Yeah, we're playing in Abigail.
It's up there, that's it.
Flo, this is where I first ever met Rodney, just up here.
Ah.
Yeah, this is the road I come galloping up with my gun out to save the day. And Dickie was just on the rock just there, I think. Or no, just here. Yeah, on the left.
And then John was face down in the mud.
Yeah, which he probably is like already now, isn't he, I reckon? Because we never saw him again after that. Yeah, just wiped off the face of the earth, I think. Eaten by wolves, hopefully.
Yes, with any luck, he's dead.
Yeah.
I mean, you lost one friend and you gained a better one.
Oh, yeah.
Exactly. Well, Dickie, you just went to help him, didn't you? And then, realised you was in mortal danger and just, you know, jumped up on a rock without a gun.
Oh, dear.
Yes. There was a moment where I thought I should probably just run away, but imagine if I'd done that, we'd have never met Rodney.
Yeah, and I wouldn't be sitting here being pulled off by you, pulled along.
Yeah.
Is any rangers there?
Oh, no. Oh, I think there was one person outside, but I don't know if that was a local or a ranger. Oh, I got a telegram.
Oh, careful, Dickie. Don't break it.
There you go, then. Get out.
Oh, thank you very much, Dickie.
car. You might have to park it somewhere. Where are you going to put it, Dickie?
In the river.
What about up that road there?
He did a very good job.
Hello.
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 How's it? Oh, how's it going?
Yeah, all right. Yeah, it's my birthday today. I'm 19.
Oh, happy birthday!
Thank you.
To keep the birthday festivities going, I do recommend you don't come to West Elizabeth.
Right. Okay.
The Del Lobos are planning something quite nefarious, apparently. So we're all on high alert. Here, so if you don't want to get kidnapped or whatever, I do suggest not being here.
Not on my birthday.
That's all I'm about. I've
got something for you.
For me?
Yeah.
Have you heard of these Del Lobos?
The what do you want to
hear? Del Lobos.
That's birthday chocolate milk.
Thank you.
Now what is that?
Well, that lady there was saying that they're a gang. Planning something nefarious.
Yeah, the Lobos.
The Lobos.
The what?
The ruffians.
Los Lobos.
The Lobos.
Yeah.
I had a beer in the casino, Clementine.
The Lobos.
Lovely. Did you enjoy it?
Yeah. I actually made a bit of money.
Me too. What do you mean they're planning on doing something?
West Elizabeth?
Yeah, they're just being complete arseholes.
Sorry, who are they?
They'll catch up with those deputies that just come into town.
Yeah.
But just going to make sure that, you know, things are, if I'm still staying out of Blackwater or not. I wouldn't recommend going to Blackwater. It's probably busy there.
Yeah,
so.
Kat told me Blackwater's a bit of a hot spot, and she said this is a hot spot. So where do you reckon is the best place? I mean, we don't really want to go at Valentine.
No, I would say Rhodes. You got the blackjack table there, so you got something to do. Go fishing around those parts. There's a fishing spot right there. Yeah, I would say Rhodes or St. Denis, really, for once.
Yeah, we just come from there.
Ranch.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Why don't we go fishing?
Yeah.
Well, I'll be going to bed soon,
Oh, yeah.
You can always go to the Aurora Basin. Just stay away from the Coulterway is my best advice as well.
Yeah, okay. Well, look, you take care, won't you? Are you on your own here, Clementine? What's going on?
I am, but it's not a big deal. This is how I've always done things, so...
Yeah,
I want you to go and enjoy your birthday, though. I'm going to go catch up with those deputies. Please enjoy your birthday.
Yeah, we'll do.
Here, do you want to borrow a book for your birthday?
A book? What book's that?
A friend gave it to me literally yesterday, so please do not lose it. But you can borrow that.
Oh, thanks very much.
It's shipped in all the way from England, so that's your birthday treat from me. But it's like a borrowed birthday treat. You have to give
it back. Of course. Yeah.
All right.
I'll bring it back to you tomorrow, all right?
The best type of birthday present, the one you
have
to give back.
Yeah.
What book is it?
Shall we just go to the camp, shall we?
Yeah.
Are you happy to stay at the camp tonight, or where do you want to go, Flo?
I can stay at the camp tonight, but I do need to check my telegrams first.
Well, let's go and do that then. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. It's my birthday today.
Happy
birthday. I'm 19.
Happy 19th birthday.
Thank you. We've been at the casino in St. Denis. I've never been there. It's great, yeah. I'm about $30 up.
Some cash?
Yeah, I'll come out with $30 more, yeah. And I had a beer, a proper beer, not a ginger beer.
Well, be careful, don't go wild.
No, I'll try not to. And you all look after yourself. I've heard that there's some proper ruffians around as well. So.
Yeah, be careful travelling between places today.
Yeah, I think we're just going to go to our camp just south of here and just stay there, keep out of the way.
Yeah, keep away from Blackwater if you can, just to keep unoccupied.
Yeah. All right, well, look, you take care. Stay safe, won't you?
And you. Happy birthday.
Thanks very much. Take
care.
Stay
safe as well.
You too. Bye.
Bear with me.
Any telegrams?
Yeah, I've got five.
Five? Wow.
Yeah, I'll need to respond to some of these. I'll be as quick as I can.
That's all right. Any DeLobos come near us, I'll blast them. Hmm. I'll just say self-defense. I think they're like Mexican fellas. And you know what I feel about Mexicans, Dickie, with that fucking Edgar. Pardon my potty mouth. I could go to the Welcome Centre and get some more alcohol.
Best not to, old boy.
Yeah.
I'll go and then I'll have a whiskey.
All right. Flo, would you like a rum? Oh, she's busy writing. I'll get her one anyway. Any fan mail, Dickie?
Just one from Toggins.
Oh, right. I didn't have rum, Flo, so I got you a beer. Is that all right? She's busy writing, ain't she?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's fine, thank you.
Okay. I've got a beer as well, and we can all go wibbly wobbly and then all pass out. I could read some of this book as well, couldn't I?
What is the book, old boy?
I think it's King Arthur.
No, that's the author. What's the book?
The story of King Arthur.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, it's very nice. Got you a cigar.
Thank you, old boy.
Someone left a brand new cigar on the table in the Welcome Centre. So I quickly, pretended to sort out my boot and picked it up.
Oh, lovely, old boy.
Yeah. Give it to you in a minute.
Yeah, at the camp.
Yeah. See, well, it feels like it's really dangerous days here in Strawberry, doesn't it, with the Del Lesbos.
The what?
The Del Lesbos.
I think they were called the Lobons, weren't they?
Lesbons.
Lesbians.
Oh. What's that?
Not sure, old boy. If I remember correctly, it's something to do with scissors.
Oh, like sort of dressmaking, that sort of thing.
I think so. I think that's what they like to do.
Yeah. Play with their doilies.
Yes, I should think so, old boy.
Yeah.
No other explanation.
No. None at all. He was riding ever so fast out of town.
Yes, maybe he's one of those lesbos.
Quite possibly.
Oh,
I feel worried now. I've got a book. If I get robbed, I'm going to lose it.
No, maybe put it in your storage or something if you've got space, I'll buy them.
Yeah, well, once we get back to the camp, I'll be able to do it.
Yes. Oh, dear.
You're getting tired, aren't you?
Yes, yes.
It's been a busy old day, isn't it?
It has been, rather. What a wonderful birthday, though, our boy. Yeah. Enjoyed yourself.
Oh, it's been lovely. Thank you, Dickie. Yeah. Ever so special. I've not had a birthday like this ever.
Oh, yes.
My father never liked me having birthdays, so my mum used to sort of secretly do it before he'd come home and beat the pair of us up.
Yes. Well, believe it or not, old boy, this is a typical birthday, sort of a fun and games and activities, and, a little bit of everything, you know.
And spending it with the people you love as well, which is nice.
Exactly. Well, I said to you before, old boy, whether you like it or not, you've got a new family now. It's me and Flo.
Yeah.
And you have your secondary, lesser favoured family, the Rangers.
Yeah, yes. But they are ever so nice to me, you know. Lesser. So it just feels nice to be so loved, really, and looked after by so many people. Do you think the cart still be there? We could go to the camp in the cart, couldn't we?
Might as well ride in luxury if we still got the cart, old boy.
Yeah, well, we paid for it, haven't we?
You did, yes.
All done then, Flo.
Yeah, I'm all done, thank you.
Right, let's get to the cart before the Del Lesbos turn up. Which way are we going? Down this way.
Oh, I don't
know. Mind the wagon, Flo. And the whole shit.
Do you think these are Del Lesbos? Do you think they're Lebanese?
I think they're Mexicans. I've heard about them before.
Mm? Are they very dangerous?
Yeah, they're like proper ruffians.
It's scary.
Yeah.
Get off.
You all right? You give you a little bit of a...
I think he's getting tired and crabby.
Yeah, yeah, a bit cantankerous.
He's not had enough of a nightcap.
No, he's been a busy day, isn't it? And you know, losing $200 has obviously pissed him off.
Oh dear. Calm down, all.
Oh, gold.
Dickie, where were you when the Pickering gang came and got you?
Well.
Oh.
Just by the bushes.
Oh, goodness me.
Oh, I've lost the door.
Oh, yes, I knocked it off on the tree, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But they don't charge me for it when I return the wagon tomorrow.
With a deposit.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. They check it for scratches and everything, don't they?
Yeah.
Oh, in that case, we're fucked.
Yeah. I've had a wonderful birthday.
Me too.
Good. I'm very glad about that.
Yeah, it's been great. It's a shame we didn't all have a lot of drink with the Rangers, but I just think they're so busy at the moment with all the Del Lesbos going on.
Yeah. And they can never relax, can they, when they're on call?
Nah, it's like 24/7, you know.
I can't be getting drunk and going out to, you know, call out so lovely while play.
No, exactly. Oh, I got
out. Where are you going, Rodney? Get back in.
I thought we'd parked.
There we go.
Perfect. Do you think we should hide the coach, though, in case some prying eyes of a Del Lesbos turns up?
Well, no.
What about if I'll stick it in the trees over there?
Okay.
I've never done one of these. It's a bit more hidden then, isn't it, over there?
Yeah.
Yes. Make with the whiskey then, I'll buy.
Yeah.
I mean, please may I have my whiskey to celebrate your birthday?
That's all right. right, yeah, whiskey. Whiskey and a cigar.
Lovely, thank you, boy.
It's all right. Here's yours,
Flo. Did you have... Oh, thank you.
A beer. And chocolate milk for later.
Oh, thank you, that's so kind.
That's all right. Oh, I'm going to put this...
Are you going to have a cigar for your birthday?
I don't smoke. I'll probably like throw up everywhere. I've never really tried smoking. I'm just going to put this...
I like the smell of the cigars. They smell real nice.
Yeah. No.
Well, cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, old boy.
Yeah.
Cheers.
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 Cheers. Chin chin.
Bottom seven. That's 12
years.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
Do you know how to say cheers in Russian?
No.
How do you say Nastrovia?
What's
or something like that.
Oh, Nastrova. Or something.
Nostrovia.
What's the hello? Is that the bibbly bobbly?
Why are these? Look at these dishes all covered in blood. Am I having a bad trip?
No, they are covered in blood and they're jumping around.
Yeah, I think I'm freaking out.
Did you cook? Did you make jam?
Oh dear, he's down.
Oh, dear.
Too much
as usual.
Too much to drink.
Oh, wibbly wobbly.
Well, I'm feeling a bit queasy actually, old man.
Why the plates? They're all bloody.
Are you going to throw up, Rodney, or not?
I think I'm alright.
Oh, lovely.
I think if I had another, I'd definitely throw up, which is good. I don't have any more.
Yes, rather good. Mind you, I think there might have been something wrong with that sausage I had for breakfast, old boy.
Really? What, do you feel a bit sick, do you?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Are you gonna throw up?
I think I'm feeling okay. Just a bit of a pain in my stomach here, but I think I'm okay. Just a bit of a pain here.
Yeah, just a little pain. Oh, God.
I've got it. Oh.
Is it? Oh, it's horrible.
I think that's it. Yeah.
Is it all
good? No, it's making me feel sick.
I am starting to feel a bit...
I'm getting queasy now watching you.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. That's the sausage. Oh, that bit of sausage.
Oh, dear.
I think I'm all right.
Hold
my hair.
That's it. Get it all out of the system, old boy. No, dear.
Is this a tactical changer or a dither?
I feel much better now.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, it didn't come out my nose this time, thank God.
That's horrible when that happens.
Yeah. Well, the last time I was really ill like that was, we had whiskey, and I think that was a bit stronger. Look out! Look, there's three piles of puke.
Oh, I'm stood in mine.
You're right.
Tonight with
3 piles of puke. Yeah, it's not too near the bed. As long as the wind don't blow it down, we'll be all right.
It's like Well, I mean, maybe the vultures will come and eat it.
Yeah. Well, there's lots of meaty, chunky sausage bits in mine and Dickie's, so they probably will like that.
Bit of egg.
There's a lot of bread in yours.
I'm going to have to retire. Oh, Finny McQueen, I'm going to have to retire.
Yeah. Night, Dickie.
Yes, have a lovely birthday, old boy.
Yeah.
Got a bit of
come here, let's have a hug.
Oh, right, you're going to squeeze me into the vomit.
Night, Dickie. Thanks for a wonderful birthday. It's been brilliant.
Bon nuit, Flo.
Nighty-night.
Thank you for inviting me.
Nighty-night.
Oh, dear. This is mine, isn't it?
Oh, mind the tent pole. You might want to get inside. Oh.
Ow.
Oh, Dickie.
I think I hit the pole. I'm just going to stay here, thank you.
You got your legs wrapped around that pole.
Yeah. Those plates are still moving about. That sorted them.
Anyway, bon nuit.
Yeah, night, Dickie. Yeah, you can have that bed there, Flo. Thanks for a lovely birthday.
Thank you for a very lovely evening.
Thanks ever so much.
Oh, yeah. It's a very nice day. Thank you very much for inviting me and for Dickie inviting me too. And I'm glad you had a lovely time.
I had a wonderful time. Mm. Yeah. Look, Dickie's sound asleep already. Yeah. He's practically
passed out. He passes
out
very quickly, doesn't he?
He does, yeah. At that age, they do.
Yeah, I think they do.
Yeah.
He's quite a snorer.
Yeah. You might want to pop some light of the... You know, the bait, the cheese bait in your ears to stop you don't hear the sounds. You know.
Or maybe some corn.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it's less stinky than cheesy.
Yeah. I'm going to probably sleep up here on the wagon, I reckon. There is a bed here, so I might as well use that. I didn't even see that before. Yeah, perfect.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I'll take the wagon.
Yeah. No, you take the bed. Yeah, look, this one here, the one I pointed to.
Yeah,
you get there because that's a nice one.
Oh,
and there's another bottle of beer there, probably.
Oh, that's good.
And then,
sleep well, Rodney.
Night. Night.